Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Before we begin, let us first start this program with a prayer, followed by our Philippine National Anthem. Glorious and blessed God, we place our work and ourselves in your hands. Anoint our creativity, our ideas, our energy, so that even the smallest task may bring you honor. God, when we are challenged, guide us. When we are weary, energize us. May the work that we do and the way that we do it bring hope, life, and courage to all with whom we minister within the organization. Bless our administration with wisdom and discernment, our employees with commitment and compassion, our clients and their families with courage and strength. Rooted in your love, may your face illuminate all activities done in your name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Kayang makilig, Diyos na sinanganan, alam ng puso, sa dikit mo'y buhay. Upang pilihan, kuya ka ng mahiting, sa mandudupin, di ka pa sisigil, sa nagatak.
Again, I am Sheila May Fuentes, one of the God Focal Point System members of Chedro 11, and it is my honor to be your MC for today's activity. Violence against women and their children, or VAWSI, is one of the prevailing social problems among the Filipino family. To address this issue, Proclamation 1172, Series of 2006 was enacted to mandate the conduct of the 18-day campaign to end VAW. The Commission on Higher Education is one with the nation in the campaign's annual observance from November 25 to December 12 with the year's theme, VAW-Free Community Starts With Me. That is why we at Chedro 11 are thankful for your attendance today. There's a lot of information in store for us with our guest speakers for this morning. So, welcome to the 18-day campaign to end VAW, or the Violence Against Women, culminating activity with GAD Focals, UNIFAST, STUFAPS coordinators, and other stakeholders via Zoom. And also, we are live on Facebook. At this juncture, may we call on Ms. Joy Barillo, GAD Focal Point System Member of Chedro 11 for the acknowledgement of participants.
I thank you, Ma'am Sheila, and good morning to one and all. I take this opportunity to acknowledge our participants in today's culminating activity on the 18-day campaign to end violence against women with GAD Focals, UNIFAST, STUFAPS, and others. Firstly, we acknowledge our speaker. with their very busy schedule, we are grateful that we were in a late.
My apologies for the disconnection. Again, good morning to one and all. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our participants in today's culminating activity on the 18-day campaign to end violence against women with our gender and development focus, UNIFAST coordinators, STUFAPs, and other stakeholders. Firstly, we acknowledge our speakers. With their very busy schedule, we are fortunate that we were able to fit in this activity and for them to be with us today. We acknowledge Attorney Septon A. De La Cruz, Director 3, Officer in Charge, Administrative, Financial, and Management Services of the Commission on Higher Education Central Office. He will be discussing on the Republic Act 11313, otherwise known as the Bawal Bastos Law. We also have Ma'am Priscilla M. Senok, Health Education and Promotion Officer 3 of the Office of the City Health, City Government of Davao. And she will be giving us situationer and updates on the HIV/AIDS and its implications. Of course, we acknowledge our ever-dynamic regional director and ever-supportive on all gender and development advocacies, Ma'am Maricar R. Casquejo, PhD, CESO 3, Regional Director, Commission on Higher Education. Regional Office 11, Education Program Specialist, Dr. Christopher Pio O. Pulido. Sir, good morning. Not to forget our Gender and Development Focal System Committee members, headed by none other, our GAD focal person, Ms. Lourdes D. Cesar. And of course, our GAD and GMMS focal person, Dr. Evelyn Ecle, and our focal committee members. Of course, again, Ma'am Emma Bonsobre. We have Dr. Cesar A. Adega IV. Sir, good morning. Dr. Lisa Suan, who is joining us from the remote. And of course, our Master of Ceremony, Ma'am Sheila Meiji Fuentes, and yours truly. And of course, Ma'am Jermaine Basister. Good morning. We also acknowledge the most important of all of your participation, UNIFAST Scholarship Coordinators, STUFAP Coordinators, Gender and Development Focal of the Public and Private Higher Education Institutions. Of course, we have the Office of the Student Services Directors, Coordinators, and Guidance Counselors. And not to forget, our Commission on Higher Education, Regional 11 staff. Good morning and thank you for your participation.
Thank you, Ms. Joy. Before we proceed, may we request everyone to turn on your cameras. Mag-documentation muna tayo and of course, show your most beautiful smiles and hold for around a minute for photo ops. we all ready?
Yes, ma'am, sir. Paki, ano lang, ma'am, sir. We have two screens only. Okay. Ma'am, sir, okay na. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And now, we will be hearing a message from our beloved and dynamic Chedro 11 leader. Let us all welcome Dr. Maricar R. Casquejo, CESO 3, Director 4.
Thank you, Ms. Sheila. My acknowledgement to our esteemed resource persons, Attorney Septon A. De La Cruz, Director 3 and OIC Office of the Director 4 of CHED AFMS, and Ms. Priscilla M. Seno, Health Education and Promotion Officer 3, the CHEDRO 11 team headed by Dr. Emma K. Bonsobre, our Chief Administrative Officer, and Dr. Luis D. Perez, our Chief Education Program Specialist, and the rest of the members of the CHED 11 Focal Points System, with special mention to Ms. Lourdes D. Cesar, as the supervisor in charge of the CHED 11 GAD program, GAD Focals, Unifast, and ISTUFAB's coordinators and other stakeholders, good morning and Merry Christmas. The CHEDRO 11 is one with the nation in the 18-day campaign's annual observance. Today's culminating activity of CHEDRO 11 on 18th day campaign to end violence against women and children is very important. Aside from the presence of our two esteemed resource persons, this is CHED 11's way of honoring the rights of women and children of our country. Specifically, our contribution in ending violence against women and children is by making ourselves be oriented with RA 1131-3 or the Bawal Bastos Law, as well as knowing the situation on HIV/AIDS and its implication. We know for facts that VAUSI is a human rights issue. It strikes at the personhood of women and children and limits human development. VAUSI is not limited to physical abuse. It can also take the form of emotional, verbal, psychological, economic, and sexual abuse. There is a need to be familiar with the recent Philippine law related to VAUSI, which is RA 11313 or the Bawal Bastos Law, in addition to what we already knew and which include RA 7877, which is the Anti-Sexual Harassment Act, the RA 8353, Anti-Rape Law, RA 8505, Rape Victim Assistance Act, RA 9208, Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act, RA 9262, Anti-Violence Against Women and Their Children Act, RA 9710, which is the Magna Carta of Women Act, and RA 9995, Photo and Video Voyeurism Act. We need to be informed. After all, ignorance of the law excuses no one. We all know that we have to do much more to respond to the cries for justice of women and children who have suffered violence. We have to do much more to end these horrible abuses and the impunity that allows these human rights violations to continue. As a summary, CHED 11 is culminating the 18th day campaign against women and children through educating the minds and hearts of our stakeholders. Aristotle said that educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. We hope that through this simple activity, we were able to educate both the minds and hearts of our stakeholders. Thank you so much once again, Attorney Sep and Ms. Sino, for being with us today. Thank you, everyone, also for taking time to be with us. Keep safe always and have a productive orientation for today. Thank you.
Thank you, Director Maricar, for your message. So, madami talaga tayong mga RAs, no? As regards to the rights of women and children who have suffered from violence. So, we are very lucky that meron talagang God. So, moving on, we will have our God updates from our God focal point person. Let us call on Ms. Lourdes D. Cesar, Education Supervisor 2 of CHED Region 11.
Okay, good morning to each and everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Since Attorney Seton is not yet around, so I will just give a update first. Not so the activity was conducted by the regional field office and at the same time the Commission on Higher Education Central Office. So if you noted that this 18th day campaign started from November 25 up to December 12, but since December 12 is a Saturday and we have also a lot of activities aligned with this month. So we have culminated this in the December 9. So actually, this activity is year-round. So every year, we conducted the PCW, the Philippine Commission for Women, conducted this 18-day campaign for violence against women. Mentioned by our director that there are a lot of Republic Act or laws before this Republic Act 11313. This is the new Republic Act signed by our very own President Rodrigo Duterte, aside from the Anti-Sexual Harassment Act of 1995, no, or RA 7877. So meron din tayong RA 9262, yung Anti-Violence Against Women and Their Children. So if you really want to attend all of the activities which is also related to your institution, I would like to flash some activities that you can Sir, maka-share na ba ako, Sir Rod? I would like to share to you the memorandum circular from the central office for a particular activities, a series of activities for this 18th day campaign. So if you have time to join with them and with us in this particular date. So this is a very important also for your institution and especially for your wait, I just want to look the Okay, sir. Mabasa, makita. So makita niyo yung ano, yung schedule. So ito yung mga line up na activity na importante din sa lahat ng institution, especially for those handling the guidance counseling, the GAD focal point system, and also the student services, because the first activity will be on December 11, no? 11 is the violence and security. This is a gender-based perspective in culture-based approach. Kasi ito yung rin naka-relate doon sa RA 11313 na i-discuss ni Attorney Septon mamaya with this activity. Another one is keeping children safe online. Kasi diba tayo ngayon is more on social media activity na yung mga bata na sa social media rin activity. So meron ding mga strategies na dapat safety yung mga bata doon sa online na ng mga threat or practical tips, no, para sa mga bata. So if you have time to attend with this particular activity, you can join with us with the central office to this two session, the violence and security for gender-based perspective, culture-based and approach, and then the keeping children safe online, threats on the our practical tips. So especially those guidance counselors. So because this is a new Republic Act, which given to discuss by Attorney Septon mamaya. So, ang coverage po ng Safety Spaces Act kasi, ang expounded concept ng sexual harassment. Kasi meron na tayong sexual harassment na law previously, but this Space 11313, Space Act, is an expanded concept of sexual harassment. A personal space safety on streets, yung mga public spaces, online, workplaces, educational, doon sa institution and training institution. So, meron ding naka-stipulate doon na penalties and severities of petition. So, magkaroon, ito din yung expanded duties and liabilities sa mga employers in the workplace or head of educational and training institute. So, itong Republic Act na, New Republic Act 113, ay talagang importante na i-disseminate within your institution or within your constituent. Kasi ito yung bagong gawa na law na applicable doon sa situation natin as COVID-19. So yung mga LGU at saka NGS are obliged to do their duties as a bearer. So tayo, in the start of this orientation, hopefully that at the end of this session or the end of this activity, each and everyone in your institution can disseminate or make your own orientation with your respective student and even faculty and other stakeholders in your institution. Kasi dapat ma-disseminate ang Republic Act na ito. Kasi dito natin malalaman kung ano-ano ang iba't ibang places na magkaroon ng cases in this sexual harassment. So, first piece of legislation in the Philippine history that not be expressed or recognized the transgender but also accord special legal protection. So, yung mga transgender na magkaroon din tayo ng a special legal protection for them. So I recognize the transphobia and homophobia as a wrong to be deterred. So dito din makikita dito sa Republic Act 11313. So hopefully na marami kayong matutunan mamaya during the discussion, and then feel free to ask questions with our speaker, Attorney Septon, because open naman siya doon sa lahat ng mga magiging question ninyo with regard to the RA 113 para clear sa inyo during the time na i-orient ninyo yung student or yung stakeholders ninyo sa totoong laman ng anti-bastos law, no, na bago lang napirmahan. So another activity update in Commission on Higher Education. If you recall, in November, we issue a memorandum on the submission of your different mainstreaming activities in your institution, especially the God focal point system or the God focal person in your respective institution. Of what have you done in the implementation and in streaming of the gender and development in your institution, in higher education institution, in terms of instruction, policies, and guidelines, then research and extension. So this year, we have already compiled different activities or different extension and researches and instruction activities in different institutions submitted in our office. But we have given an ample time to those state universities assigned to compile those recognition. Then hopefully that those institutions who have not yet submitted in their accomplishment with regards to the instruction, extension, and research should be submitted in our office so that it will be included in our compilation. And each compilation will compose of the video presentation of the different institution with regards to their implementation and the mainstreaming of gender and development in their institution. So if you recall last year or 3 years ago that we awarded a lot of institution, both private and public institution, in mainstreaming the gender and development aligned or related to the CMO1 of series of 2015. So for this year, we really compiled those accomplishments with the institution to give justice for those institution who mainstream the different activities in God in their institution with regards to extension, research, and policies, especially in the curriculum, inclusion in the curriculum. So with this matter, we will be announcing to those institution who submitted their accomplishment in mainstreaming the gender and development, at the same time the winner of those best practices in mainstreaming the gender and development in related to the issuance of the CMO1 series of 2015. So that's the update of our gender and development activities in Region 11, as well as the mainstreaming activities in our in different institution in the Region 11. So thank you very much and good morning. So I think Attorney Septon. Ah, okay. So since Ma'am Presi is already here, Ma'am Presi.
Good morning.
Ah, okay. So Ma'am Shi, Ma'am Presi will be the one to
okay.
Discuss the first topic.
Okay, thank you, Ma'am Lourdes. For our first topic on today's activity, our former Chedro 11 God focal point person is excited to introduce to you our guest speaker for situational and HIV/AIDS updates and its implications. We may now call on Dr. Liza C. Suan, Education Supervisor 2 of CHEDUGU 11, to introduce to you our speaker.
Good morning. Am I already heard? Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, Ma'am Sheila. Our speaker this morning is one of the active leaders in the advocacy in the prevention and control of HIV/AIDS. In Davao City AIDS Council, she's always the team leader, the collaborator, and a good communicator. As Davao City AIDS Council Secretariat at the same time, urged the public to visit the City Health Office through the Reproductive Health and Wellness Center. A committed and dedicated registered nurse by profession who is presently working at Davao City Health Office as the Health Education and Promotion Officer 3. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Ma'am Priscilla Madula Senok. Ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Good morning to each one, but I would like to correct Ma'am Lisa. I am not a graduate, I am not a nurse, but I am a graduate of Bachelor of Arts major in English. Okay, pa. I graduated from the Ateneo de Davao University, and I'll be giving you a situational on HIV and AIDS. Is it, I heard, okay lang ba, na ano ba? Narinig ba ako?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Okay, no, thank you so much. So, ano ko lang yung screen share ng ano input ko po. By the way, Ma'am Liz, I am so conscious about time. Ilang oras po ba ako? Am I given 1 hour for my input? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Mute ako, unmute.
Unmute. Okay. Sige. Okay. Kita ba yung ano ko? Presentation?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. HIV and AIDS, no? During the time of pandemic. And it's very important also to know what's the relationship between HIV and the current pandemic that we are embracing right now. Hopefully, we don't want to embrace the pandemic, but reality bites, we are here in this situation wherein it devastates, it alters our daily activities in life. Just like HIV, masabi natin, ay, wala na, na ang HIV, no? Parang nawala ang HIV, but it's growing. No, it's growing despite the pandemic, it's there, no? Since we are all... We are all human beings, and the number one transmission of HIV is sex. Okay, so I'll begin my presentation. Okay, HIV is not only about sex, actually. It's something to do with the multifaceted factors. Why is it that HIV has increased, no, in numbers? One is migration. Well, we know very well that OFWs, no, go to other countries for job opportunities, and we do not know their engagement there. And as well, once they go home, there is no mandated HIV testing for that because the law is very strict on privacy and upholding confidentiality and as well as the right not to be tested or to be tested. And then economic factors. Okay, poverty is the number one. Despite its pandemic, no, we have recorded sexually transmitted infections, no? That means people continue to engage in sex, and as well as it's still in the flesh industry, still active. And number one is political factors. So how is the state, no, running? How is the state influence, no, the HIV as a program? No? And then biological factors. Oh, we know very well that women are very much easily be infected with HIV. It's because of these biological factors, and as well as we as a human being, no, we as human beings, we are very much prone, no. That's how we relate with others, no. That's the biological factors, and then the sociocultural double standard gender issues. I've heard, no, during the introduction that how gender issues affect very much, no, in our society, the sociocultural aspect that we're in, how the transgenders, excuse me, are being treated, and as well as women itself, no, how the gender biases affected very much in terms of the increase of HIV cases. So, ang lahat ng bagay ay magkaugnay. Everything is interrelated. Okay? Yan, interrelated lahat. And as well as sa HIV and risk and vulnerabilities. Okay? Then number two. Okay. Human being, try to see the... Okay, sandali ha. Okay. Try to see the factors. Human beings, no? As human beings, we are always thinking about every split of a second, we are thinking about sex. Okay? And whether we like it or not, sometimes, no? Even when we ponder about relationship, when we engage into a relationship, split of a second, we talk about sex. Okay? It is in the brain, no? It is in the embedded in our brain. And that is why every relationship, that is why we are very much aware of how our young people today, sex is love is equals to sex. That's it. Okay. Now I will go to sexually transmitted infection. I have to include this. It's because that the there is a connection between sexually transmitted infection and HIV. Okay. So number, I just want to go over with it. Because I have to know with my time, no, I have my time limits. So, una, looks can be deceiving. Hindi mo alam kung sinong may STI dyan, no, if you are going to engage in sex. And even the COVID, you do not know sinong may COVID, sinong may infection as well as HIV. And then, ano bang STI? It's an infection transmitted through sexual contact and even through non-sexual means. Remember that? Non-sexual means. Okay. Ito yung common STIs, no? And then, we have the bacterial, viral, protozoal, fungal, and skin parasites. And then we have this genital molluscum. Okay. Now, it's a chronic infection. It is a lesion in the skin. It's like a pearl bomb. No? Kapag puputok yan, sa iba naman, tutubo na naman. Okay. That's can be transmitted through sexual contact. And next is the gonorrhea. No? Ito yung 3 to 7 days ang kanya incubation. So if you engage someone with sex, no, or engage someone with sex, you do not know that this someone has gonorrhea and it affects your genitals, the throat, and anus. Okay, ang symptoms niya is scrotal swelling in men and as well as pelvic inflammation in women. Okay, I would like to ask, no, since may I know, can we have someone to know what's the Bisaya term of penis, please? Okay, is there anybody knows the Bisaya term of penis? Ayaw, hindi nila alam. Hello? Ano ang penis?
Birdie.
Ano?
Birdie.
Birdie, ano pa, please? Sige daw, ano pa? Oy, nahiya kayo, ha? Ano pa ang the Bisayan term or any...
Utin, ma'am, utin.
Na-unmute si ma'am. Ma'am, na-unmute ka po.
Mute ka, ma'am.
Parang ano, pakiano lang sa, okay, marinig na ba ako?
Yes, ma'am. Marinig na po.
Marinig na?
Yes po, ma'am.
Okay. Anong, ano, Bisaya ng, ano, vagina? Sige daw, anong Bisaya ng vagina? Terminology. Bitong. Okay, how about sexual intercourse?
Iyot.
O iyot. Okay.
Gorgeous, ma'am. Gorgeous.
Ah, gorgeous. O, marami yan. O, meron jug-jug-a. No? So, marami yan.
Jug-jug-a, iskemburgo, and iskemberters.
O, sige. Para kanya nag-anya ng, ano, sa circus. Okay? How about masturbation? How about masturbation?
Lulu, ma'am.
Okay. Masturbation, how about anal sex? Anal sex.
Ilubot, ma'am.
Ilubot, okay.
Alubi.
Alubi. Okay. Now, how about oral sex?
Chupa.
Chupa, ma'am.
Okay.
Laps, ma'am.
Okay.
Laps.
Ay, okay. Laps. O, di ba, lollipop, o microphone, marami, right? So, I've heard some of you were laughing, no? Because it's when we talk about sex, that's off limits in our family, right? Do you agree with that?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That's off limits and it's prohibited not to discuss about it, about sex at home, no? Have you experienced na pitikan din atong mga baba, no? When we were small, when we were in our high school days, no? Kapag we discuss about sex, we discuss about iyot. We were being reprimanded not to discuss about it because it's bastos, no? That is why it's good to hear about the law about bastos. So that's it, no? So meron tayong ano kung kailan natin gagamitin yung mga terminologies. But inside the class, of course, you will not say, hey, huwag kayo mag-iyot dyan. Oh, you really have to sanitize the word, no, with your students before discussing it. Kasi para sa kanila bastos yan. Because it's a culture, no? It's a culture that when we discuss about sex, it's really a prohibited one. It's a taboo, no? That's it. So that's why I'm telling you about this because I will be showing to you about penis, vagina, and all these things. Okay? Sige. Next, slides. Okay. O natakot na siya, hindi na siya mag-move. Okay, sandali ha. Ayaw na niya mag-move. Stop share. Sandali ha, bakit ganito hindi na mag-move? Okay, that's it. Gonorrhea? That's it? Kapag kumakain ka ng snacks dyan? Okay, nakikita ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, people. Okay, that's gonorrhea sa lalaki. No, and then ang gonorrhea would affect no the reproductive system. We have to cause infertility, abdominal pain, no, scrotal pain, and soreness of the vagina kapag babae. Okay, tapos may yellow discharge yan from the sex organs. And then chlamydia, ito yung ano very silent STI. Akala mo wala pero meron pala, no. It can also affect urethra, rectum, and your throat, no. May mga discharges din. Next, ito yung chlamydia. Okay, it also causes ectopic pregnancy and even infertility to women. And as well as there is a burning sensation, pain when urinating. And also there's a presence of blood in the urine. Okay, next is syphilis. Okay, you have to note that makukuha ito sa paghahalik at pakikipagtalik. Okay, remember, at first ito ay tsangkwela o singaw, nasa bibig. Pero hindi ito masakit actually, it's not painful. But pwede ka nang maka-infect, no? Ito, no? Ito yung tsura ng syphilis. Okay? Unang yugto ng syphilis, ganito, kinakain yung skin. Okay? And the next, ito yung pangalawa, no? Na sasakit na yung may sugat na sa bibig, may ano kumakalat na maging matigas sa talampakan, it's just like tigdas. And as well as pamamaga ng lalamunan, no? You have fatigue, you have fever, patsi-patsing pagkakalbo. You have to remember ha, kapag may mga may baldness dyan o may kalbo dyan, remember, wala yung sipilis ha, baka sabihin nyo may sipilis ang mga kalbo. Okay? Wala yan. Okay? Sige, next. Ito yung rash. Ganyan. And then, ito yung mga, ito rin ang iba't ibang mga picture ng may syphilis. Okay? And then, ang consequence nito, kaya ito could cause blindness and mental problems, okay? And serious heart abnormalities, okay? And then, especially kung may ana, buntis na babae, no? It can infect ang bata when after delivery, no? May ma-infect na with syphilis, okay? Next, it's a bacteria actually. The latent stage, ito yung grabe na, it can cause your heart and as well as 5 to 20 years talagang kapag hindi ka na gamot nito, I mean, that's the worst thing, okay? Next is the trichomoniasis, okay? Mabula siya, mabaho, mabirding katas na lumalabas sa ari. Madalas maghapdi sa pag-iihi, matinding pangangati ng ari actually. So, ito yung ano, itsura niya. Ito yung cervix, ha? Redness ng cervix. Ito yung tinitinan sa speculum. Okay? Redness ng cervix. Okay? Next, ito yung trichomoniasis, no? Ito yung symptoms. Ito yung picture, no? Painful urination din, and as well as smelly discharge from the sex organ. And as well as reddening and swelling of the sex organ. Okay? Okay, ito yung ano rin, causes urinary tract infection. It's also increased the risk of HIV infection. Actually, ito yung risk, no? Kahit basta may ano ka, STI, nag-increase talaga ng risk of infection ng HIV. Okay, candidiasis, nana, malapot at makapal, makati, at mahapdi sa pag-iihi. At it's very painful when you have sex, no? When you have sex. Kung mag-iyot mo, it's really, ano, masakit. And then, ito yung itsura, but actually, it can, usually, kapag nag-ano ka, nag-chupa, no? Kapag nag-ano ka, nag-oral sex ka, talagang na-ano yan, no? It can, ano, also infect your, makikita din yan sa tongue, sa, ano, sa cervix, ganyan, ang itsura. Then, can you just imagine when you kiss someone with having that, ano, sa tongue, no? So, it's really good, no? When you engage with sex, actually, it's really good to really have someone with you na talagang very conscious about na wala talagang mga ano sexually transmitted infection. And then pityriasis, we do not consider this as an STI, but we just include this in our advocacy. Ito yung signs and symptoms. May maliit na sugat sa labas ng ari, mapuputing itlog sa ari, no? And then may mga dugo, no, sa panty or brief. Ito yung pityriasis. Ito yung tinatawag natin na ano, kuto sa ano, diyan sa bugan, kumbaga sa Bisaya bugan, no? Sa magano yan, it will really stick to your pubic hair, no? Tsaka it can only be seen through the microscope. Ang liit-liit niyan, no? Kapag gagamit ka ng mga panty sa iba na ano, talagang ma-infect ka nito sa tuwalya. And usually when you do chupa or oral sex, no, you do ano, syempre kapag nag-chupa ka, no, mapunta yan sa kilay mo, no, sa kilikili, ganyan. So ang infection talaga, di kuto yan, no, kuto ng ano mo, ng ari mo. Next, ito yung crabs or pubic lice, pubic lice, sorry for that. Ito yung symptoms, itchiness in the pubic hair and other parts of the body. So, yung consequence, because of excessive itchiness and scratching the skin is prone to infection, actually, no? Kasi, syempre, dahil makiti masyado, no? So, ganyan. And then, we have bacterial vaginosis. Yan, walang simptomas, pero mabaho siya. Ito hindi consider na STI ng CDC, na? But then, we don't consider this in our advocacy, it's because that it's something with hygiene. That is why we do advise always na talagang kapag gumagamit tayo ng napkin, it has to be only a maximum of 2 to 3 hours or even 2 hours, no? Panty liners, dapat 2 hours lang siya kasi kapag magbasa na siya, mag-loom ang bacteria. At yun, prone ka for infection for this, no? Tsaka mabaho talaga ito. Okay? Kaya nga yung ano, kapag gumagamit tayo ng sabon, no? Ginagamitan natin ng sabon na it has to be mild soap. Huwag yung huwag yung ano, very ano, kumbaga isog na sabon, no? Or yung anong ginagamit usually ng mga babae, kapag palagi yan, kasi may natural flora ang ating vagina. Natural flora na talagang God has his own way of protecting women actually. So ang ano is yung vagina natin may natural flora na mag-protect na hindi tayo basta-basta ma ano ma-infect ng whatever bacteria. But then kapag ano palagi ka nagpupunas ng oh, isog na sabon, no? Grabe yung kumbaga tied na, no? Lalo na kung tied ang ginagamit. It will really ano, mawala yung natural flora ng vagina. Okay? So, yan. And then ito yung tsura niya. Okay? The next is the genital herpes. Okay, walang sintomas actually. Parang chicken pox ito. Then sa babae, pangangati, pananakit at paltos ng ano, labas ng ari. Mahapdi sa pag-ihi, ano? It's really painful when you engage in sex and abdominal pain. Okay? Masakit ang binti at paa, hita, okay? So ganyan. Ito yung genital herpes, redness. Para na siya og ano, multiple shallow ulcers. It's painful urination, no? It is caused by herpes simplex virus 2. Okay? So incubation na is period is 2 to 12 days. Sa kanya yan, wala, parang wala pa yan, but then after 12 days makikita na yan, nag-appear na yan. So it's not safe, no, when you engage in someone, when you say ah, wala ito, malinis ito. You can never tell people. Okay? And then we have genital herpes, that's it. Okay? Parang ano, sorry, parang senior citizen itong model namin. Kung meron sana kami makikita na medyo young na ano ito, no? Medyo pisot din, no? Okay? Next, I'm so ano with words. It's because I hope walang minors dito. That's why we are sanitizing the words. It's because this is how HIV and this is sex. Okay? And then genital herpes. Okay? We have this genital herpes, a sexual transmitted disease that is caused by the herpes simplex virus. Transmitted skin to skin. Imagine skin to skin. Okay, contact during sexual intercourse. Usually, kapag gumagamit ka ng condom at kapag meron dyan sa ano, hindi na-cover ng condom, still you can be infected. Okay, infected with a herpes. Okay, so may mga health complications talaga ito, lalo na kung buntis ang babae at during childbirth. The babies during childbirth na-transmit ito sa bata. Okay, ito yung genital warts, no? Pangangati kung saan, para itong moral na siyang kulugo gamay, no? Para na siya og kanang kulugo gamay, but then once nga wala nimo na gi ano giatiman, no, you did not care for it, and then actually the culture itself, ang kultura kasi natin, we are ashamed, no, to show our organs, no, ang penis saka vagina, mahihiya tayo. That is why maraming ano ayaw kapag nagka-warts, kahit na ano pa na sana pwede pang magamot ng ointment. So hindi na, kapag lumalaki na siya, para na siyang cauliflower. At imagine, maisalin ito sa sanggol, ha? And then, once you are, mapagamot mo ito, no? Pero nakakahawa pa rin kapag ano, kasi yung kulugo lang ang ano, yung kulugo lang ang ginatreat mo, pero yung virus na sanhi nito, andyan pa rin, no? Ito yung itsura, no? So it's just like cauliflower, no? It's caused by human papilloma virus. Kaya sa ang City Health, nag-ano ang City Health na yung bata na nag-engage ng sex, hindi pa nag-engage ng sex at mga bata pa, no, below 14 yet, 13, I'm sorry not to remember the age, tinaano namin ng HPV vaccine, no? And this can be directly transmitted from skin to skin during sexual contact. Ito ay hindi pwedeng maano ng condom. Kapag nagko-condom ka at the surrounding ng penis at vagina nandyan, at pwedeng maano yung anus mo, pwedeng mag-cover sa vagina, no? Para talaga siyang ano cauliflower. So warty growths yung lesions niya. Okay? So pwede ka talagang makaano makahawa nito. And when you hold it and your hands na andyan yung virus, pwede ka rin when you touch, pwede ka rin makaano makahawa ka pa rin. Okay? That is why kapag ano pa no, kapag maliit pa sana, parang ano lang na kunti pa masyado, ah, sabi ng doktor, it can be cured by ano, ointment. But then kapag ito na ang itsura, para ng corona, no? Talagang you're undergo ano, yung ano talaga scrap 'yan. No, scrap 'yan. And it's really very painful. Okay? Next, ito yung warts. Okay, that's it. Itching or burning around the sex organs, makati din ito. Then through surgery ito, the warts can be removed. Surgery. It cannot remove the virus. Okay. 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 Bakit? Sige, mamaya na lang question ha. Okay, next, genital warts ito. Okay, that's it. And okay, it can cause cervical cancer. Ito, okay, pwede ito may anal cancer, meron din, no? So makakos siya ng cervical cancer. Okay, next. Okay, hepatitis, no? Alam niyo na yan, hepatitis A, B, and C, no? Ngayon, pwede nang maano sa laway ang B, no? That is a recent development when we had our conference in Manila. Okay? Then, it's good na sana maano din ang mga estudyante nito, lalo ng hepatitis A, no? Maruruming pagkain, and we do not know the, ano, street food, no? Yan, ang B, pwede siya gatas ng ina, no? Mother to child, and infected needles. Okay. And I have, depende kung acute siya or chronic, pwede pa maano yung atay. Ito yung mga chronic niya, no? Yellowish na yung mata, no? And it can also cause your liver, no? Then, ang complication talaga nito is cervical cancer, sterility, abortion, childbirth, and death. Okay? That's it. Ito yung ano, ito yung baby, ano? It can cause blindness to the baby. Okay? And next is that, ito din, no? Somebody asked me when I had my lecture in with Barangay Captains, no? I was asked, ma'am, bakit ang redness ng mata, no? Sabi, redness ng mata. Then I told them that sometimes kapag nag-oral sex ka, napisikan yung eyes mo ng bacteria, so nag-redness yung mata. Then somebody asked, ma'am, ano palang gawin namin kapag ano daw, makipag-ano sila, no? When they engage in oral sex. Sabi ni isang barangay captain, ma'am, mag-ano na lang tayo, mag-sunglass tayo kapag mag-oral sex. So, yan ang sinasabi ng mga barangay, yung isang barangay captain. And they all laughed at it. But then I told them, yeah, we laugh at this. But then, we have to note that our nature as human beings, we do explore so much on sex. And saan naging pleasurable ang sex. Okay? Next is that, smear. We do this at the Reproductive Health and Wellness Center. If you have students, lalo na in Davao City, and I hope in other provinces, you also have your health centers, and may nag-smear yan, and may ano yan, program on treating sexually transmitted infection. Okay, ganyan ang ginagawa. Okay. And next is that, ito yung common signs and symptoms ng STI, and please remember this. Pain, passing urine, no? Kapag sakit, umiihi. But hindi lahat ng sakit na umiihi, may STI yan, ha? Usually, UTI, pwede ka rin mag-ganyan, no? Then pain, having sex, no? And then yellowish abnormal discharge. And then ulcerations and then abdominal pain. So these are the 6 signs and symptoms of STI. Okay. Next, ano ba ang link ng STI and HIV? Ano ba ang link dito? And it's very important to note this, okay? Una, pareha sila, no, ang STI and HIV, pareha ng sexual mode of transmission. Pareha sila ng ano, a person with STI easily gets HIV, no? It passes the virus to another. And then, next, same preventive measures. And then, isa lang ang clinic na pinupuntahan, and that's the Center for Education on HIV. Okay. Next, ito yung history. I will not dwell on this, okay, because magbigay pa ako ng ano, statistics. Okay, HIV in the Philippines in 1984, una siya nag-appear. And then, yan, in 1998 pa nag-craft ng law. So, nag-spread na talaga siya, no? Then, why do you have to know really about HIV? No? Ito yung ano? Because sabi na lang mga ano, sa foreigners lang yan, no? It will not affect us. Okay, sa mga ano lang yan, sa mga transgenders or sa mga gays, no? Or sex workers. But actually, we are all... at risk and vulnerable to HIV regardless of your race, color, and creed, regardless of your political status, regardless of your economic status, we are all vulnerable to STI and HIV and AIDS. Okay? So walang exemption na. No one is indispensable with regard to HIV and AIDS except if you are going to prevent ourselves not to get infected. Okay. Then what is HIV? Okay. It's the virus that can only infect human beings. Ito yung HIV, ito yung virus nag-infect. Okay. Ano yung sinisira niya? It's the immune system ng tao. It the effect of the virus is to create deficiency, a failure to work properly within the body's immune system. Talagang sinisira niya ang immune system. Okay? So it is the virus, it's a retrovirus. Bakit ito ay retrovirus? It produces itself, no? It can reproduce itself. Kaya nga yung gamot natin, antiretroviral drugs. Kasi yung ano organism is a retrovirus. It can replicate itself. Okay? So ganyan. Ito yung HIV na nag-transmit, ha? Okay. So ano bang HIV infection? It's a lifetime infection. Okay? Talagang andito yung forever. No? So sabi na pag-ibig is mawawala, but HIV andyan, no? It's forever. So no vaccine to prevent it, no cure, no signs and symptoms kapag HIV pa. It has no signs and symptoms and you do not know people having HIV. Okay, HIV destroys the immune system. HIV, it's the one that causes AIDS. Okay? Okay. Then, ito yung immune system, just like the CD4, your protein in the body, your army in your body, that's it. Once it enters into your body, at na-succumb, no? Ang yung mga armies in your body, na-succumb siya. Ito yung ano natin, siya yung nag-protect sa ano natin, sa body natin, sa body system na hindi tayo magkaubo, no? Kung magkaubo nga, madali lang tayong na-cure sa ubo, sipon. Pero kapag may HIV, talagang ang HIV talaga kakainin niya at overwhelmed niya yung ano natin. It attacks our CD4 cell. Okay? It can multiply inside and gradually kills them. Okay? So nag-destroy ating resistance sa lawa, sa body natin. Nag-destroy siya sa resistance. Next is that ito yung progression of HIV infection. Okay, at first makikita mo yung HIV infection. Pagpasok niyan, mataas pa yung immune system mo. Okay? Kaya nga may window period tayo, 2 weeks to 3 months may window period. At itong window period, pwede ka nang maka-infect. Wala kang signs and symptoms nito. It's very normal, okay? Kasi mataas pa yung immune system mo. Kapag marami na, nag-multiply na yung virus sa katawan mo, okay? Nag-multiply na siya, it becomes an AIDS condition. Ano yung AIDS condition? This is the period wherein symptomatic ka na at may signs and symptoms. Okay? Symptomatic ka na, this is an AIDS condition. Symptomatic with signs and symptoms. Walang namatay sa AIDS, namatay ka sa complications. Okay, dahil ang AIDS is just a condition wherein overwhelmed na ang iyong body with the virus. Okay? Ito yung time na nag-ano ng treatment ng ARV. Pero ngayon, no, ang RHWC, ang City Health Office, and even SPMC, kapag may HIV na, diretso ka agad ng treatment ng ARV. So depende yan sa doctors na nag-ano sa iyo, responsible for you. Okay? Then if wala kang ginawa, wala kang treatment, hindi ka nagpa-test, then it will really, your body will succumb to death. Okay? So that's it. Next, ano ba yung mga fluids that transmit the virus? Apat lang, people. It's semen, it's blood, it's vaginal and cervical fluids, and breast milk. Okay? Apat lang siya. Next, apat na principles. Excuse me. Apat ng principles ng transmission. ESSE, yun ang tinatawag namin. Exit, survival, sufficient, and entry. Kapag sinabi mong exit, yung apat na fluids, okay, yung apat na fluids, it's the semen, the blood. Kapag nag-exit yan, okay, pag nag-exit yan, dapat alam nyo, magsusurvive ba siya? Okay? Sufficient, marami ba siya masyado? Sufficient ba siya? At the most important is may entry. Nakapasok ba sa katawan mo? And usually, the portal of entry is vagina and anus. Okay? And as well as the skin kapag injecting drugs ka. Okay? So that's it. That's ESSE. That's the four principles of HIV transmission. And ano ba ang AIDS talaga? Okay? Pareho lang ba ng HIV and AIDS? Pareho lang ba, people? Did I hear answers? Parehara ba ang HIV and AIDS? Is it the same? Hello, people. Andyan pa ba kayo?
No, ma'am.
Okay. The same ba ang HIV and AIDS?
No, ma'am.
Oh, okay, that's good. Oh. HIV, it's the virus that transmits, that infects. Okay, ang AIDS is the condition of your body. Okay? Na yung ang virus is talaga sa katawan mo. It is acquired and your immune system is compromised already and it's really deficient. Okay? It can no longer fight any bacteria or any viruses that enters into your body. Okay? When we say syndrome, it's an experience, it's a collection of symptoms which could be fatal. What are the symptoms? Pwede ka magka-TB, pneumonia, cancer, na kahit ano, andyan na yan. Okay? Kaya it's not easy if you have that HIV, you're a person living with HIV, at saka you're not living a very healthy lifestyle and you still engage in sex without prevention, at talagang masisira talaga ang buhay mo dyan, no? I mean, physically, you'll be devastated. Okay? Dahil ito yung mga opportunistic infection. Okay. So, itong panahon ng COVID, okay? I know you're very much aware of the COVID. Since I also know with the DOH as a health education and promotion officer, no? Itong COVID kasi, it's ang target niya ay yung immune system mo. Kapag mahina yung immune system mo, ay talagang you'll succumb to that, no? At talagang grabe yung complications. Okay? Lalo na kung may HIV ka because you are already immunocompromised. Okay, kahit na nagte-treatment ka ng antiretroviral drugs, still with other people who have no HIV, still you are still vulnerable and at risk to COVID. And as well as to COVID, and kapag may HIV, mas lalo na kung may HIV ka, talagang COVID will be successful, no? Talagang i-destroy niya ang katawan mo at marami ng complications. Lalo na kung mga fungal infections, ganyan. No? Ito yung opportunistic infection ng HIV. Itong swollen lymph nodes, talagang kapag hindi ka makatreat, wala kang treatment on HIV, talagang puputok yan. Okay? At lalo na kung may cancer, the Kaposi sarcoma shingles. Okay? Ito yung mga opportunistic infections dahil pumapasok sila sa katawan mo na dahil mahina yung immune system mo. Okay, and very at risk to COVID. Okay? Alam niyo naman ang pandemic ngayon, no? Parang napapraning tayo kapag may inuubo lang, wala na, no? Kapag sinisipon ka, wala na, parang napraning ka na baka may COVID ka. Unlike HIV, no? Makikita mo na lang na you will know you have HIV kung magpa-test ka. You will only know you have HIV kung magpa-test ka. But with COVID, the same. Kung alam mo lang may COVID ka kapag magpa-test ka, but with the symptoms itself, you will say hey, may COVID na ako, lalo na kung body malay, no? Fatigue, high fever, no? And as well as sipon, ubo, no? So that's it. And next is that now we'll talk about the transmission of HIV, and it's very important. It's only three transmission of HIV. Okay? One, unprotected penetrative sexual intercourse with an infected person. Kahit na makipag-sex ka ng sampo, kaya mo ang sampo na isang araw. Grabe ka naman, no? So, kaya mo ang sampo na isang araw, kapag wala silang HIV, then hindi ka ma-infect. So, the transmission is sexual intercourse with an infected person without using prevention. Okay? So, that's it. Pwede siya babae to babae, lalaki to lalaki, lalaki to babae. Okay, and we have to note na there is already a man-to-man sex. Okay, and it's getting higher. Okay, yung engagement na ngayon ng man-to-man sex. Okay, and it's painful also to note that kung man-to-man sex and the problem is when the other person, the other male is married, so kapag makipag-sex sa wife, then yan, no? Ma-infect din ang wife, no? For that. Lalo na kung mag-pregnant. Ayan, no? So talagang ano din ang HIV. Very kapag men to men, we have to note, no, na as much as possible also kapag lalaki na may we really have to be cautious about it because you are also transmitting HIV to your wife and even to your infant. Okay, next. Next, infected blood and blood products. Okay, blood transfusion, HIV infected donor, and sharing of infected syringes and needles. Okay? Answer tayo dito, wala pa, no? Hindi masyadong noted yung blood-to-blood products infection sa Davao City. And even the whole country, unti lang yung percentage, no? Kasi very much, very cautious din ang Red Cross, ang hospital ngayon, no? Very conscious sila niyan, no? About HIV. They were already educated about HIV transmission, especially on the blood donations as well as transfusion. Okay? Next is mother to child. Okay? Infected mother to child. Tatlo lang ha. Please remember. Una, through infected, having a sexual intercourse with an infected person, infected blood, and infected mother to child. Okay? It is through pregnancy and natural delivery and breastfeeding. Okay? Of course, during pregnancy, alam niya, no? Ang child while inside your fetus, yung kinakain niya, yung ano, yung mother, yung umbilical cord, no? Nag-ano yan sa mother, no? Nag-connect yan sa mama. And natural delivery. We are very much aware, kapag natural delivery, syempre, dadaan yan sa birth canal and there is blood. Okay? Kapag maano ng bata ang blood, then pwede siyang ma-infect. And as well as the breastfeeding. Okay. May mga studies din kapag nagbe-breastfeed ka, sana before na maging pregnant ka, you undergo test ng HIV para at least kapag alam mo na may HIV ka and you go treatment, no? You undergo treatment on antiretroviral drugs, there's a big possibility na hindi maano ang bata, ma-infect ang bata kahit na nagpasuso ka, no? So, pwede rin na kapag ano, there's a lot of ano options. And it's good na kapag pregnant ka, you really have to see a OB-GYN, no? Kasi sa SPMC, meron dyan, OB-GYN natin na focus on HIV, no? Lalo na kung pregnant women. And it's also good na kapag when you plan to have pregnancy, no? Ang mag-asawa at alam nyo may HIV kayo, no? You really have to sit down with your OB-GYN kasi yung magpo-program yan, no? Ganyan, okay? So kasi ang breastfeeding pa rin, may antibiotic pa rin yan for the child. So it's also good. So, depende na yan kung ano yung recommendation ng health provider mo. Next is that, how can I protect myself from HIV? Okay? Just like asking ourselves, how can I protect myself from COVID infection? So, ang COVID lang talaga, alam niyo yung prevention ng COVID. But with the prevention ng HIV, diba? Una, abstinence. Talagang you have to abstain from sex. And abstain from sex, especially when we do a campaign with young people, we do always adhere to abstinence and as well as wait, no? Love can wait, parang ganun, no? But then there are a lot of children as of this time, no? Children and young people na talagang very sexually active na, so we cannot avoid telling them to use protection, especially the use of condom. Okay? Because we have to be practical, we have to set our feet on the ground that there are young people now are very much sexually active and engaging in sex. Okay? We cannot be idealistic and saying, hindi yan, kasi huwag kayong mag-ano, kasi makasalanan yan. Talagang ano yan, no? Very ano yan sa mga bata. Next, be mutually faithful. Very important to, especially in a relationship. Okay? When you have a relationship, mag-asawa, kung dalawa kayo faithful sa isa't isa, pwede hindi kayo magamit ng condom dahil safe kayo. But then, kapag there is a problem in your relationship, no? At nakipag-sex sa iba, talagang dyan ang danger. Kahit nasa men-to-men na sex, no? You really have to be faithful with each other. Kasi pareha lang yan, relationship. No, and it should be bounded, it should be binded by love, no? Hindi yung kasi kapag sex lang ang nasa sa mind natin, talagang dadami talaga ang HIV. Okay? Then consistent correct use of condom. Please remember it should be consistent. Sa first lang sa pakipag-sex, gamit ka ng condom. Sa ikalawang rounds ng sex, wala na. Okay, dapat consistent siya. It should be correct. Okay, it should be correct and as well as isang beses lang gamitin ng kondom, huwag niyong labhan. Okay? Baka labahan niyo kasi you really have to ano, 'di ba? Yung kaya nga sinusuot ko itong t-shirt ng City na magtigom ng pera. So paano kayo makasave ng pera, no? Kapag yung condom balik-balik niyo na di ano, eh, magkasakit kayo, nawala pa rin yung pagtigom niyo ng pera. Okay? And then wala rin yung save niyo ng pera. Don't use shared injecting needles. Okay? Kapag ano, as much as possible, just like in Cebu, this is very prevalent in Cebu, no, na kahit na sa mga jails, no, na gumagamit ng injecting drugs. Yun ang problema kasi nag-clash ang yung ano sa Philippine Drug Agency at saka yung City Health, na yung City Health providing new syringes at doing counseling, but the PDA would allow that, no? So that's it. They have to sit down for that. And Davao City, swerte lang tayo. I don't know. Somebody make hint na meron dito sa Davao City, but still they're afraid to come out in the open. And next, education and early detection. Now, what we are doing right now is an information education. And I hope you are all going to share that with your colleagues and as well as to students, no? And early detection. Early detection is very important. If you have engaged someone with sex, or blood transmission or transfusion, or if you think you're exposed to, no, then HIV testing is already free, okay? In Davao City, in Tagum, in elsewhere, no, sa provinces, libre ang HIV testing, okay? Next, yun lang, you really have to undergo counseling first because marami din nag-suicide, no, kapag malaman nila nagka-HIV, na marami nagka-depress, okay? Ito yung ano, preventing blood transfusion, no, blood safety program, universal precautions, and as well as ang anong sinabi na harm reduction program. Dapat kapag nag-inject ka ng drugs, bago ang kanyang syringe. But then we do not encourage people to do ano, injecting drugs. Okay? Next. A positive woman can still give birth to an HIV negative babies if ito yung mga ano, precautions. Take ARVs during pregnancy. That's what I am trying to emphasize a while back. Okay? And then deliver the baby through cesarean operation because natural delivery will endanger your baby. And as well as use infant formula instead of breast milk. And as well as, that's it. And as well as undergo HIV testing and early detection. Okay. Next. Ito yung ano, you will only know you have HIV if, paano? Through antibody testing. Okay? Ito lang, antibody testing. Hindi mo makikita sa mukha. Ah, dahil biot yan, may HIV yan. No. Ah, may lesbian yan, may HIV yan. Ah, yung mukha niya, ano yan? Ah, kalbo yan, may HIV yan. No. Okay? It is only through HIV testing that a person can know she or he has HIV. Okay? Next. Ito yung mga activities na you can do not allow HIV transmission. Wala itong HIV transmission kasi once we see someone or a friend na hindi tayo makipag-shake hands dahil may HIV, baka mahawa ako. Or to sit beside someone with HIV, baka mahawa ako. Wala yan. Casual contact, sharing of food, utensils, shaking hands, hugging or kissing, coughing, sneezing, using public phone, or visiting a hospital, walang HIV dyan. But, pwede kang magka-COVID. Okay? Sa COVID kasi, okay? You know what? Diba? Social distancing is very important. No hugging, no kissing, no shaking of hands, sharing of food and utensils, you have to avoid that because COVID is there. The virus is there. Okay? Usually, kapag may hinahawakan kayo mga surfaces, dapat disinfect mo. No, unlike HIV, pwede ka dyan. But with COVID, you have to remember, nandyan yan ang virus. Okay? Lalo na in a very enclosed areas, yan, ang COVID, nandyan yan. Okay? And then, yung urine, saliva, sweat, tears, wala yan. Donating blood, sharing toilets, insect bites, swimming pools, wala yan. Pero sharing toilets with COVID, nandyan yan. No? You have to disinfect your toilets. Even your tables, lahat. Doorknob, lahat. Kasi yung mga surfaces, posible may HIV dyan. I'm sorry, may COVID dyan. Okay? But with HIV, pwede ka dyan. Wala yan. Dahil tatlo lang ang transmission ng HIV. Ano yun? Unprotected sexual intercourse, infected blood, and infected mother to child. Okay? So, ito yung when I was lecturing about gender and HIV and as well as a gender reproductive health and HIV, I'm always emphasizing the role of men. No, the role of men na paano mo ayong ma-show yung pagmamahal mo sa asawa mo by being very faithful, dahil kapag hindi ka naging faithful sa relationship, you are also contributing a lot, no, sa women's ano devastating their lives. Okay, so kailangan lang talaga na anong role ng lalaki diyan sa family, role ng lalaki diyan sa asawa at sa kanyang mga anak, very important diyan sa adolescent reproductive health. Okay, kahit lahat ng bagay ay magkaugnayan. That is why when I lecture about HIV, I always connect that, no? Usually, kung whole day na ano, ginakonect ko talaga yan, yung role ng lalaki, dyan sa reproductive health, no? Then, treatment. Ito yung antiretroviral drugs. So, you really have to see your doctor. Meron dyan sa SPMC. Sa RHWC, we are also RHWC under the City Health Office. We are also providing treatment, no? People living with HIV. Ito yung antiretroviral drugs, okay? Available for free so the DOH, no, and treatment hubs. Meron na ngayong prophylaxis, no? The World Health the World Health Organization maybe is also emphasizing about the prophylaxis, but then some are very reluctant to that, no, because baka ma-immune na daw ang katawan natin pagka magka-HIV, hindi na magtalab, no? Yun din yung mga debate as of the present, but then I have no update. And somehow, wala pa rin update if really people are now using prophylaxis. Maybe some, but only dahil mahal ito po. Mahal masyado ito. Okay? Impact ng individual, psychosocial and emotional. Sino ba namang magsasabi, hey, I have HIV people and I enjoy it. Wala. Okay? So emotionally, you'll be affected. Okay? Psychosocial and emotional, you'll be affected because there are still a lot of people who discriminate people living with HIV. No? And second, social exclusion, stigmatization, and isolation. Okay? Isolate ka dahil natatakot sa iyo, especially sa community. Physical effects. Remember when you take the ARV, the antiretroviral drugs, may mga physical effects din yan. No? Lalaki yung panga mo, yung tiyan mo. May mga physical effects din yan. Okay? Some experienced people living with HIV taking antiretroviral drugs, undergo hallucinations, sasakit ang ulo, ganyan. Okay? Next is a difficulty finding assistance and support. Kasi ayaw mo magsalita, ayaw mo pupunta doon sa agencies na maghingi ng tulong because the fear of being discriminated because you're a person with HIV. Okay? Anong impact sa community? So marami din tayong may mga opportunities for violence, no? It's good na accepted na yung mga people living with HIV, pero still, they do not come in the open because yun nga, discrimination for PLSIV in the community is still existing, no? You'll be a subject for gossiping, subject for mockery, okay? Next, economic impact. Of course, marami, no? Marami ang mga, I have counseled many na talagang gusto na mag-alis sa trabaho. It's because of, may HIV sila and they are afraid na malaman ng mga co-workers nila, okay? Tapos yung ang ARV lang ang libre, pero yung ibang mga complications ng gamot, hindi ang libre. Okay? So, yun. You have undergo depression. Yan. So, it will really affect your productivity. Okay? So, clear ba? So, I'm going to share with you the statistics. Okay? Sandali ha? Okay. Okay, sandali. Ano ko lang kasi may may di-share sa akin na okay. Sige. Okay. What we want is that we campaign for zero new HIV infection, zero discrimination, zero AIDS-related death. Okay? We had just our World AIDS Day and it's really increasing pa rin. Kahit na may COVID, okay, ang number ng HIV. And we have to note that fear, no? Yung fear ng mga tao to undergo testing because natatakot pa rin. It's a permanent emotion of the inferior man is fear. yun, permanent emotional ng tao. May gender issue pa rin dito, man pa rin, walang hindi kasali ang babae. Then nothing in life is to be feared, it's only to be understood. Now once we understand about HIV as well as its prevention and transmission, we'll never be afraid of, okay? And then ito yung ano natin. Thank you and ingat lagi, okay? I will share to you may time pa ba ako? Okay. Itali, ha? Ano lang, i-share ko lang yung ano, yung okay. May time pa ba ako? Sandali, ha? I will go. Okay. Sige. So we have here the HIV/AIDS antiretroviral treatment registry of the Philippines. In 2011, we have 6. In 2014, we have 16 every day. 2016, 25. In 2019, malaki talaga, 35. But in 2020, daily naging 21. So what's really going on in 2020? Because it's COVID time. We are in a pandemic, okay? But still, the whole country also, it registered an increase of HIV cases. Ito yung cases per month. Okay, sandali, ha? Okay. Kung titingnan nyo, no? 2018, 19, and 20. Titingnan nyo yung 2019 talaga. Every month, malaki. Okay? But pagdating ng January, wala pa itong COVID. 2020. February, wala pa. March, nag-start ang COVID outbreak. Okay? Ito na, April, May, June, July, hanggang September. Parang lumabas na ito. Tapos na ang ECQ nito. O GCQ na ito. Okay? Then October. Okay? So ito yung number of newly diagnosed cases per month. Okay? Next. Ano yung summary of HIV diagnosis and death? Okay. Kung titingnan mo, total reported cases is 81,169 from January 84 to October 2020. Okay? Okay. As of October, no, total cases 735, October yan. Okay. So in January to October, 6,362. January 2015 to October 20, 58,715. I-plus ang October. So, male pa rin ang dumadami. Lalaki pa rin. Female, ito, 4,000 ang female. Okay. Now, let's go to the age group. Increasing talaga ang 15 years old and below. Okay? Then, ang titingnan ninyo, ang 15 to 24 years old, 23,000 na siya. Dumadami siya. And mataas ang 15 to 24. Tapos, ang 25 to 34, 41,000. 35 to 49, 14. And meron din, humihirit pa rin ang 50 years old and above. Okay, ito yung reported pregnancy and as well as reported death, 4,444. Okay, so you have to note that despite the pandemic, meron pa rin mga tao engaging in non-protective sexual intercourse at meron pa rin tayong danger, no, on HIV na it is growing, no, it's fast and furious. Okay? Ito yung modes of transmission. Still, nangunguna ang sexual contact. Okay? Titingnan nyo yan. Dito lang tayo sa 73,000 ang sa lalaki, ang sa females, 4,590. Male to female sex. Yan, maliit lang. But male to male sex, tingnan nyo yan. It's 43,114. Sex with males and females. Yung pwede ang lalaki sa babae, pwede rin sa lalaki. It's bisexual sexual intercourse. Ito 'yon. So sexual contact ito, malaki ang ano rin, bisexual sex, no? Bisexual contact. Okay? Then blood to blood products still. Okay, tingnan niyo lang, no? Maliit pa, 5 and 15, injecting needles. Tapos needle stick injury, yung mga nurses natin, mga doctors. And then mother to child. Okay, sa okay, merong male. Mother, bakit merong male ito? Mother to child. 104 sa female. Sa lalaki ito, nag-infect sa mama, no? Tapos wala ko tayong may non-available data. Okay. Next, age group. Tingnan nyo yan. As I had explained, tingnan nyo ang graph. Okay? Ang red is 25-34. Dumadami. It's yung medyo orange, 15-24. Tingnan nyo yan. Okay? Next is art initiation per month. That's why I'm showing you the slides. Dahil sa dami ng ano everyday na transmission, maliit lang ang nag-avail ng antiretroviral drugs treatment. It's maybe because of COVID, may mga na lockdown, may mga na quarantine, no? So ganon. So ngayon, due to reporting delay, ma-delay din yung reporting dahil sa COVID, no? So marami talagang setbacks ang COVID pandemic sa mga programs natin actually. Even our immunization program, no, nagsasuffer din siya. Then, ito yung number of cases, advanced infection reported in the Philippines, January 2020. Tingnan nyo yung graph, no? Tumataas siya. Tumataas. Okay? Okay, tingnan nyo. In 2020, lumiit siya. O, tingnan nyo yan. 2020, lumiit. HIV case and advanced infection reported. Advanced infection reported. In 2020, ito yan. O, liit pa siya. Kasi COVID ito, pandemic, parang ng pandemic. But still, meron pa rin nag-i-engage, no? Meron pa rin nag-i-engage ng sex. But in 2019, talagang, parang fast and furious. Tumataas talaga. Okay? At ito yung male-to-male sex. So, okay, in region, we are, kung saan kayo na region na belong. Okay, that's it. That's how your region contributed. Okay, that is how your region contributed to the rising cases of HIV in the different regions. Okay? Next, so we have a number of cases diagnosed by region of residence. Okay, ito yan. Tingnan nyo lang yung data. I don't no need to mention that. Try to see the data. Okay, paano na-contribute ang HIV natin, ang region natin dyan sa cases ng HIV to the whole country. Next is that cumulative number of diagnosed per year. Okay, a mode of transmission. Yan. Ang titingnan mo yung red, that is MSM. No, ang red, yan, tumataas. MSM yan, no? Siya yung mataas masyado. Ito yung male to male, no? Male to female, yan. Tapos yung green sa people injecting drugs and as well as others, yun, sa baba. Okay? Sa mode of transmission. Next, adolescents, no? Sa mga young people, we have this. Mother to child, 6%. Male to female sex, yan, 396. No? January to 1984 to October, no? Male to male sex, no? Meron na mga bata, no? Nag-engage na talaga ng sex. 15 years old, no? And below, then children. And then we have this, blood transfusion. We have sharing, injecting drugs. Maliit lang din, 3%. And sex with both males and females, 730. So, okay, this is our data. So children, adolescents in engaging in sex with HIV. Okay, ito yung OFW, of course, OFW. Okay, ito yung OFW. Okay, kung titingnan nyo, yan. Nag-increase din siya in 2019. Okay, so tingnan nyo yung graph. Okay. Ito yung ano, AIDS and sex. That is why I'm showing these slides to you, AIDS and sex, so people diagnosed with HIV who engage in transactional sex. O ngayon, kahit nag-COVID, may bumibili pa rin ng sex. Okay? Yung lalaki, accepted payment for sex only. Yung mga lalaki, of course, we have mga lalaki na bayaran, no? So, October 20, we have 28, 30%, 27. Yan. No? January to October 20, we have 214. In December 12 to October 20, October 2020, ito. 31%. Ang lalaki is 2,494. Ang babae na accepted payment for sex is 191. Paid for sex only. Okay? Paid for sex. Ito, paid. Ikaw yung nagbayad. Okay? Ikaw yung bumibili. Okay, ito yung sa first, ikaw yung nagpabili. Itong male, siya yung nagbayad. Yan, oh. Malaki. Okay? So, month of October, it's 48 people engaged in sex. Na siya yung nagbayad. Engage in both. Ikaw nagbayad, ikaw yung nagpabayad. Yan. Ito yung data. Okay? At ito ay most probably hindi ito gumagamit ng protection. Okay? Kasi sabi nila, it's ma'am, it's hindi talaga masarap kung gumagamit ng condom, but actually it's not. It's in the mind. Okay? When you do a condom and then you are very conscious that you are wearing condom and you would say in your mind and the dictate of your mind in your brain, hindi masarap talaga, hindi sasarap yan. Pero para sa iyo, because you love that person and you engage in sex and may emotional attachment for that, so kahit na may condom ka, still sex is pleasurable. Okay? Next, the demographic data of reported death among people living with HIV. Sa lalaki, ito nga, lalaki, dahil marami din sa kanila na nagka-HIV, marami din ang ito na namamatay, January hanggang 84, 2020. Sasabihin natin, maliit lang palang namatay, kunti lang palang namatay, no? But then we do not know, no, na ano ba ang recording dito. Kasi mostly kasi kapag may HIV na namamatay, hindi yan nagsasabi na may HIV ba yan, no? Ganon. Sabihin lang immunocompromised, alam na natin yan. Pero but then, still, no, we are still, kahit na nung we had a meeting with DOH and asking for this, talagang still, it's a debatable issue na talagang titingnan natin kung ano talaga ang exact data for those who died with HIV. Ito maraming namamatay sa 25 to 34 and 35 to 49. Okay, just look at the data, please. Next is that number of HIV women, okay, who are pregnant. Okay, look at the data. Okay, the green 35 to 49 na nagkaasawa at nabuntis na may HIV. Okay, yan, sa 2020. And 25 to 34, yan. Yung ito yung 25 to 34. Okay, 15 to 24 ito. Okay, so ito yung below 15 years old. Okay, so that's it. So marami tayong mga pregnant women who are now having with HIV and got pregnant. Okay, ito yung demographic data, no, sa namatay, no, male, ito yon, no. Okay. So taking antiretroviral, ito yung mode of transmission na namatay. Male to male sex, marami. October 2020. With sex with both males and females, 74, and male to females, 37. Ito yung cumulative data from January 1984 to October 20. Ito yung data. Okay? Okay. Punta tayo sa province, no? I'm really very sorry because this is March 2020. We cannot ask for data from the DOH for the update for the province, no? For the province. It's because of the COVID pandemic. Our human resource, personnel are very much busy with COVID response na dahil marami na din ang na-infect, no? Talagang before it's LSI na locally stranger individuals, no, locally stranger individuals, no, ang at first, no, ang COVID transmission, but now with communities, no, tumadami ang communities kaya marami ang nag-lockdown at saka nag-quarantine, and then after that nagpupunta na sa mga offices, no, sa mga agencies, no, we cannot deny that na even our office, no, meron din sa other offices, meron din, and we cannot deny that because COVID is everywhere and the transmission is very na it elevates to an airborne, no, ang elevate na sa airborne lalo na ko in closed areas, of course, and the hospitals airborne niya, hindi makalabas yung virus, so talagang pumipili kung saan siya lulugar, no, so ito yung Davao de Oro, no, Davao City, of course, mataas pa rin ang Davao City, Davao del Norte, Davao del Sur, and Davao Occidental, and Davao Oriental. Ito yung March 2020. Just try to imagine, March ngayon, but then it's COVID time, March 20, right? March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October. Hopefully, November, hopefully sana, no? Nag-reduce ito dahil may COVID. But then as we all know, no? During the COVID, marami ang we have we discussed about the violence against women. Dumadami ang violence against women during the pandemic because nag-lockdown at maraming mga depressed na mga tao, maraming nawala ng mga trabaho, and talagang maraming din mga bata na ng abused. So this ang nangyari ngayon, it's really devastating for people and it really alter our daily lives because even an HIV, kahit na ngayon, no, hindi natin alam talaga kung still it's because na walang mga trabaho, people still engaging in selling sex. Okay? Next, ito yung sex, male, female, ito yung male. So, ang female at present, 290, sa March, 294. So, ito yung ano, by sex. Okay. Ito yung by age group. Yes, ma'am.
Sorry for interrupting.
Yes.
You have 5 minutes left na lang
po. Yes, yes. Presentation. Yeah, almost done. Okay, so we have this age group. Just to try to see the age group. Just watch. And then 25 to 34, ang marami. And then we have mode of transmission. Tingnan nyo, bisexual, hetero, MSM. Marami ang MSM. Yan. And then sa OFW in the region, we have 318. And then LHB and ART, no? Still on treatment, no? Sa region. And then death, we have 206 at up to March. And then, thank you. Okay. So, we have to remember always my last, ano, everything is interrelated. Lahat ng bagay ay magkaugnay. So, lahat ng bagay ay magkaugnay. So, with HIV and COVID this time, we have to always be cautious and prevent yourself not to get infected with COVID, because COVID will also alter your health status, your health, no? Alter your health at marami ito epekto. With HIV, especially with HIV, dahil immunocompromised na. Okay. Thank you very much, and I hope I have shared a lot, and I hope I enlightened some aspects of the doubts you have about HIV and COVID. So I cannot discuss well about COVID, about the PDITR, the prevention, the detection, as well isolation and treatment and reintegration. So because I'm only tasked for HIV. Thank you very much, and may God bless us. Please stay away and get prevented of HIV infection. May God bless us all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Priscilla, for the information and updates. We must really be aware that HIV/AIDS is growing. Itong mga sexually transmitted infection is present to people we do not know and also to people we may know, and the implications of these diseases. Ma'am, we really had fun, and of course, not to forget the learnings from your presentation. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Before we proceed with our next speaker, let us call on Ms. Lourdes D. Cesar, Gender 11 God Focal Point Person, to award the Certificate of Recognition to our guest speaker.
Okay, good morning. Thank you very much, Ma'am Priscilla.
Yeah, so thank you so much.
To award this certificate of recognition is hereby awarded to Ms. Priscilla M. Senok, our Health Education and Promotion Officer, City Health Office, Davao City, for her exemplary contribution as resource speaker on the topic HIV/AIDS. Situation and implication in Davao Region during the CHED Regional 11 webinar in the observance of the 18-day campaign to end violence against women and children on December 9, 2020 via Zoom. Given this 9th day of December 2020 at CHEDRO 11, Davao City, Philippines. Signed, Dr. Maricar Casquejo, Director for CHEDRO 11. So, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am.
For Ma'am Priscilla Seno.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ma'am Lourdes. This time, our CHEDRO 11 God Focal Point Person is very much excited also to introduce our next guest speaker on RA11313, known as the Safe Spaces Act or the Bawal Bastos Act. Let us call on again, Ma'am Lourdes, for the introduction.
Okay, once again, good morning to each and everyone, to Director Maricar R. Casquejo, our Energetic Regional Director, to our Chief in Technical Division, Dr. Luis D. Perez, to our Chief in Admin and Finance Division, Dr. Emma K. Bunsobre, To all my colleagues in the government service, especially in CHEDRO 11, and to our participants from different higher education institutions, from GAD focal point person, guidance counselors, student services directors and coordinators, and scholarship coordinators, good morning. It is my honor and privilege to introduce our guest speaker of today's activity relative to our celebration in the 18-day campaign to end violence against women and children. Please bear with our speaker because he will be discussing the new Republic Act 11313 or Safety Spaces Act or Bawal Bastos Law. Our guest speaker is a highly talented, energetic, and committed person. But despite of this busy schedule for so many invitations all over the Philippines, and for a busy office work in CHEDRO Central Office, because it's a year ending and all financial aspects should be settled. Because he is our director in the Office of Administrative Financial and Management Service, or AFMS, he still have the time to be with us today in this very important educational activity. Aside from AFMS, he is also our chairperson of the Gender and Development Secretariat of the Commission on Higher Education. So please help me welcome, with a virtual clap and smile, Attorney Septon A. De La Cruz, our guest speaker. Attorney, good morning.
Hello, good morning, Lourdes. Good morning. Good
morning.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Region 11. Can you hear me, Lourdes?
Yes, yes, attorney. Very clear.
Ah, okay. Medyo na-pressure naman ako dun sa introduction mo na yun. Highly talented, energetic. Naku, mukhang wala akong energy today.
Yeah.
Oo. Anyway, again, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat, no? And first of all, thank you for the opportunity. Thank you, Region 11. I am very grateful to Director Maricar Casquejo and the whole Region 11 team, no, for the kind invitation to be part of this very important forum. So again, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. I was listening to Ma'am Priscilla a while ago at ang dami-dami kong natutunan, no? So I'm sure marami din kayong natutunan kay Ma'am Presi this morning because yung topic niya, ito yung mga topic na hindi natin yan binabasa, no? Hindi natin binabasa kasi parang awan ko ba, hindi natin feel magbasa ng mga ganito, pero I'm so glad that we had one Ma'am Presi, no, an expert on the topic of HIV at nagkaroon tayo ng pagkakataon na makinig ng mga ganitong mga topic para din mapag-ingatan natin yung ating mga sarili. Anyway, my topic for today is, or my task for today is to discuss with you Republic Act 11313 or otherwise known as the Safe Spaces Act or sa karamihan tinatawag nila ito na Bawal Bastos Law, no? So I'm not sure if I can start sharing. Lourdes, can you help me share the document or the PowerPoint?
Yes, attorney.
Hello, Ma'am Maricar. I can see you. This is screen, no? So, magandang umaga sa iyo.
Thank you so much, attorney Sam.
Nakutulungan mo ako dito sa presentation na ito, ha? Hindi ako expert sa mga itong mga bagay-bagay. So, please. Paano na ba ito, Presi? Lourdes, sorry. Lourdes, paano na ito? How can we share the PowerPoint?
Okay, so Rod starting to share.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Oh, by the way, today's activity is still part of the 18-day campaign, no, to end the violence against women, no. That is the reason why, if you can see, yung virtual background ko ay kulay orange, no, because yung PCW DSW pwedeng gawing activity, no? Part of the 18 day campaign is pwede din tayong mag orange, no? Oranging of the logo, oranging of our lobby, facade, or oranging of anything, because sabi ng PCW, yung Philippine Commission on Women, orange is the official color of VAUSI. That is why you can do it by adorning your, you know, your the lobby, your logo with color orange or cloth, no, or by using some lighting effect, no, para maging orange ang ating kapaligiran, no. This is to honor the campaign of PCW to end violence against women. And you can see also sa slide ko, ay kulay orange din ang aking slide this morning. So, walang political color ito, no, hindi ito politically motivated, no. So, walang kulay politika yung kulay orange natin ngayong umaga. So if you will see here sa slide natin, it says here it's bawal bastos, because we'll be talking about mga hindi kanais-nais na mga bagay, no, na kung saan ay ipinagbabawal na ngayon sa ating batas, which is Republic Act 11313, no. Well, I mentioned earlier, Lourdes, pwede ba ako mag-move?
Yes, attorney. Pagkohospital
ni... Bawal bastos. So next slide, please. So can I also, ano, move the slide? I'm not sure. Okay, sige. You help me na lang, Lourdes, ha? Okay. So I mentioned earlier that my topic for today is Republic Act 11313, no? This is an act defining gender-based sexual harassment in streets, public spaces, online, workplaces, and educational or training institutions, providing protective measures and prescribing penalties therefore. So, I am sure karamihan sa atin na present today ay alam na ang batas na ito, or for those who have not heard about this law, then sabay-sabay natin siyang talakayin ngayong umaga, no? So, for the information of everyone, Republic Act number 11313 came into law only in 2019, last year lang siya. So fresh na fresh ang batas na ito, bagong-bago, because this was signed or it lapsed into law sometime in, I'm not sure what month, no? Siguro pa mga like July or June of 2019, no? June of 2019. So, next slide, please. But 24 years ago, prior to the enactment of Republic Act 11313, we already have this Republic Act number 7877. No? This is the act declaring sexual harassment unlawful in the employment, education, or training environment. So, as early as 1995, meron na tayong sexual or anti-sexual harassment law. Ito yung palagi nating naririnig, no? Yung Republic Act number 7877, bago pa man ang Republic 11313. So, under this Republic Act number 7877, ito ang next slide, please. Under this act or under this law, ang sabi sa batas is that sexual harassment may be committed by an employer, employee, manager, supervisor, agent of the employer, teacher, instructor, professor, coach, trainer, or any other person who, having authority, influence, or moral ascendancy over another in a work or training or education environment, demand, request, or otherwise requires any sexual favor from the other, regardless of whether the demand, request, or requirement for submission is accepted. So ito daw ang sexual harassment. No, ito daw yung sexual harassment. Dun muna, Lourdes. Balik pa tayo, please. Oo, na slide. Previous slide pa. Yeah, yan muna. Oo. Yan muna. Under this law, you will see here that the sexual harassment could be committed within the educational institution or sa workplace lang, and the offender should be the one which has the influence or moral ascendancy over another. Diba? So yun, take note of that, no? Take note of that, no? That the offender could only be those with influence or moral ascendancy. Okay. So with this Republic Act 7877, in 2017, no? In 2017, because ayon sa ating mga mambabatas, they feel that kulang pa ang batas na ito, no? Para what do you call this? Para ma-penalize pa yung ating you know, yung mga acts natin that is considered as bastos. That is why in 2017, during the 17th Congress, Senator Riza Ontiveros introduced this bill, no? Itong bill na ito. Can we share this the screen sa screen now? Next slide, please. Okay, so Senator Ontiveros introduced this bill, no? Senate Bill number 1326, entitled "The Act Defining Gender-Based Streets on Public Spaces Harassment, Providing Protective Measures and Prescribing Penalties Therefore," no? So, ayon sa ating mga mababatas, this Republic Act or this bill or this Republic Act 11313 is intended to address existing gaps and issues on equality, security, and safety of both women and men in private and public spaces. So, based on the explanatory note of Senator Riza, no, sa mga hindi familiar sa pagpapasa ng batas, for every bill, no, na pinapasa ng ating mga mambabatas, there is what you call the explanatory note, no, yung reason why a bill is being passed, no, to become a law. And ayon kay Senator Riza Ontiveros, isa sa mga principal authors ng batas na ito, ang sinasabi niya dito is that there is now an overwhelming, no, 88% of women aged 18 to 24 years old experience sexual harassment in the streets, while wolf whistling and catcalling are the more common cases. Other forms of sexual harassment include lascivious language, stalking, rubbing or touching, indecent gestures, exhibitionism, and public masturbation. 58% of these incidents take place on the streets and small alleys. They have also been reported to happen in public vehicles, public washrooms, schools, and workplaces, no? So medyo mahaba. I will not anymore finish reading the explanatory note, but this was the reason why this bill was passed. It's because I mentioned earlier, aside from this data presented by Senator Riza Ontiveros, the intention really was to address existing gaps and issues on equality, security, and safety of both women and men in private and public spaces. So, dahil siguro nakulangan talaga yung ating mga mabatas ng ating Sexual Harassment Act of 1995. That's exactly the reason why na ipinasa itong batas na ito. Next slide, please. So, with this Republic Act 11313 now, this law now expanded the definition of sexual harassment in the workplace and education training institutions to include the following. Letter A, an act or series of acts involving any unwelcome sexual advances, request or demand for sexual favors, or any act of sexual nature, whether done verbally, physically, or through the use of technology such as text messaging or electronic mail, or through any other forms of information and communication systems that has or could have a detrimental effect on the conditions of an individual's employment or education, job performance, or opportunities. Next slide, please. Letter B, of the same section. Next slide. This sexual harassment under Republic Act 11.3 also includes the conduct of sexual nature and other conduct based on sex affecting the dignity of a person, which is unwelcome, unreasonable, and offended to the recipient, whether done verbally, physically, or through the use of technology such as text messaging or electronic mail or through any other forms of information and communication systems. Next slide. Next slide, this also includes the conduct that is unwelcome and pervasive and creates an intimidating, hostile, or humiliating environment for the recipient, provided that the crime of gender-based sexual harassment may also be committed between peers and those committed to a superior officer by a subordinate, or to a teacher by a student, or to a trainer by a trainee. So you will see here that based on this provision, as again, this definition of sexual harassment under Republic Act 11.313, as compared to that of the definition of sexual harassment under Republic Act 7877, you will see the difference here, no? That the main difference now is that in 7877, only persons in authority could be charged as offenders. There are no provisions, no, under 7877 that provides for violations for harassment by subordinates or peers, no. So, sabi daw sa 7877, yung may mga moral ascendancy lang, no, superiors lang yung pwedeng ma-charge ng sexual harassment under 7877. But under now the definition, under the definition under Republic Act 11313, it says here that it is no longer necessary for the aggressor to be one's superior. A peer or someone of lower rank may now be held criminally liable under this expanded definition of sexual harassment. So ang ibig sabihin, meaning under 11.313 now, anyone now can be an offender. So hindi lang kailangan yung boss lang natin, hindi lang kailangan yung teacher lang natin, hindi lang kailangan yung president, no? Ngayon, pwede na kahit sino ay maging offender ng sexual harassment under Republic Act 11.313. Okay, any question? So medyo clear naman yun, ano? So also, under 11.313, another difference is that under 7877, sexual harassment may only be committed within the workplace or within the educational or training institutions. Under 11.313, the offense of sexual harassment could be committed not only in workplace or workplace or educational training environment. Now, under the Safe Spaces Act, sexual harassment could be committed also in public spaces, streets, online sexual harassment. No, so naging apat na, no, yung pwedeng pag there are no four places wherein you could commit sexual harassment. No, under 11.313. No, a workplace, educational institution, and educational institution and training institutions. Now, the law added the streets and the public and public spaces and also online sexual harassment. Ito yung mga pag-uusapan natin ngayong umaga na ito, no? Yung mga articles on gender-based harassment in streets and public spaces, harassment in online harassment, and in workplace and training institutions or educational institutions. We have here a question. Is abuse by student to a teacher included in superior officer by a subordinate? Is abuse by student to a teacher included in superior officer by a subordinate? Superior officer. under 7877, sir, we have here a question from Sir Amado, no, of OSSA scholarship, no. The question is abuse by student to a teacher included in superior officer by a subordinate? Under 7877, under 8777, student, they are not, they could not, superior officer, so hindi siya magfo-fall under 7877 as a violation of sexual harassment, but under 11313 now, a student now could commit sexual harassment against faculty or teacher. Yes, next question is, can we file RA 7877 and RA? Yes, both. Kasi wala namang na-supersede, no? Walang na-supersede and na-batas, no? Both laws exist, no? 7877 and 11313. The passing of 11313 did not supersede the provisions or amend the provisions of 7877. So, pwede po. Okay. So, next slide, please. Article 1. Under Article 1, gender-based harassment in streets and public spaces. So under this article, under Section 4 of Article 1, gender-based streets and public spaces sexual harassment, the crimes of gender-based streets and public spaces sexual harassment are committed through any unwanted and uninvited sexual actions or remarks against any person, regardless of the motive for committing such action or remarks. So, can we have the next slide, please? So, under this section, gender-based streets and public spaces sexual harassment includes catcalling, wolf whistling, unwanted invitations, misogynistic, transphobic, homophobic, and sexist slurs, persistent and invited comments or gestures on a person's appearance, relentless requests for personal details, statement of sexual comments and suggestions, public masturbation or flashing of private parts, groping, or any advances, whether verbal or physical, that is unwanted and has threatened one's sense of personal space and physical safety and committed in public spaces such as alleys, roads, sidewalks, and parks. Acts constitutive of gender-based streets and public spaces sexual harassment are those performed in buildings, schools, churches, restaurants, malls, public washrooms, bars, internet shops, public markets, transportation, terminals, or public utility vehicles. So it's like anywhere, no, we could commit with this definition now. Well, unlike kanina kay Ma'am Presi, no, maraming mga pictures, maraming mga graphic pictures na na-share. Hindi ako nakapag-prepare ng mga ano, ng mga pictures na yon to share with you. So, I am sure alam naman natin itong mga ibig sabihin ng mga naka-mention dito sa section na ito, no? Okay. So, under Section 11, Section 11 provides for a list of specific acts and their corresponding penalties, no? So, item number one of Section 11 provides that for cursing, wolf whistling, catcalling, leering, and intrusive gazing, taunting, cursing, unwanted invitations, and the like, no? Under this category, the penalty is that the next slide, please. The penalty for the first offense would be a fine. Next slide. A fine of 1,000 pesos and community service of 12 hours inclusive of attendance to a gender sensitivity seminar to be conducted by the PNP in accordance with the LGU and the PCW. Second offense would be arrest of minor this is for 6 to 10 days or a fine imprisonment or a fine of 3,000 pesos. And for third offense, arresto minor, 11 to 30 days imprisonment and a fine of 10,000 pesos. So, can you just imagine sa pagiging bastos natin, eh pwede tayong makulong, no, or ma-fine ng penalty. So, next category, next slide. Under the same section, the next category of offenses under this section would be making offensive body gestures at someone and exposing private parts for the sexual gratification of the perpetrator with the effect of demeaning, harassing, threatening, or intimidating the offended party, including flashing of private parts, public masturbation, groping, and similar lewd actions. So you will see from the first category, medyo nagle-level up siya, no? Medyo nagle-level up siya. Or nagle-level up siya. From, if you will see from the first category, it's more on verbal, no? Verbal yung offense, no? Like cursing, wolf whistling, catcalling, mga unwanted invitations, remarks, and all that. But under category number two, meron ng body gestures, no? Doon sa offender. May exposure na ng private parts, no? May may public masturbation, groping, and similar lewd actions. So may action na ginagawa, which is offensive, no, doon sa tao na feeling niya na violate siya. So because nag-level up itong offense na ito, definitely yung penalty nito ay nagle-level up din, no? So can we share the slide for the responding penalty for this group of offenses under this section 11. So for this group of offenses naman, for the first offense, kanina 1,000 pesos, but this time, for the first offense, the fine of 10,000 pesos na, no? And community service of 12 hours, inclusive of attendance to a gender sensitivity seminar to be conducted by the PNP, no? In accordance with the LGU and PCW. The second offense would be the arresto minor. Kanina, the second offense was only 6 to 10 days, but this time, it's now 10 to 30 days, and the fine is now 15,000 pesos as against 3,000 pesos kanina. For the third offense, arresto minor, it will now be for 1 day to 6 months and a fine of 20,000 pesos. So, next group of offenses under the same section. Next slide, please. Ito kanina, ito yung first level of offenses kanina ay verbal, and then the second category ay verbal pa din na may konti ng, na meron ng action, no? May action na on the part of the offender. Under this category number three is that ito sinasabi dito, no, na stalking and other acts committed or mentioned in section 11 A and B when accompanied, no, by touching, pinching, or brushing against the body of the offended personnel, or any touching, pinching, or brushing against the genitalia, face, arms, groin, breasts, inner thighs, face, buttocks, or any part of the victim's body, even when not accompanied by acts mentioned in section 11, paragraphs A and B. So in this third category or third group of offenses, so talaga nag-level up na, no? Kung mapapansin natin, meron na siyang touching, no? Meron yung brushing, no? Meron ng touching of may brushing against the genitalia, face, arms, groin, breast. So with this offenses, dahil matindi siya compared to other groups, yung penalty naman ito ay mas mataas, no? Can we share? So for the first offense, arresto minor kaagad, so 11 to 30 days kaagad, no, na imprisonment, no, and penalty of 30,000. For the second offense, arresto mayor, or 1 month and 1 day to 6 months, or a fine of 50,000 pesos. And third offense would be arrest to mayor in its maximum period or a fine of 100,000 pesos. So that's it, no, for section 1. So, article 1, before we move to article 2, any questions so far? So, okay. So now we can move to article 2. Under article 2, so under article 2, yes, Lourdes will share with you the I don't know, the copy of the presentation this morning. Okay, so under article 2, it's provides for the online sexual harassment. So especially now that mostly, no, tayo ngayon ay we're engaged in online work, no, like most of us were in work from home arrangement. So talagang most of the time we are online, no, and as early as 2017, I'm not sure kung magpaano ba tayo kasi hindi pa natin iniisip in 2017, no, when this law was passed, na darating pala yung panahon na karamihan na sa ating gagawin because of this pandemic ay magiging online. So this is now being penalized, no, yung online sexual harassment. So under section 12, it provides that gender-based online sexual harassment includes acts that use information and communication technology and terrorizing and intimidating victims through physical, psychological, and emotional threats, unwanted sexual, misogynistic, transphobic, homophobic, and sexist remarks and comments online, whether publicly or through direct and private messages, invasion of victims' privacy through cyberstalking, and incessant messaging, uploading, and sharing without the consent of the victim, any form of media that contains photos, voice, or video with sexual content, any unauthorized recording and sharing of any of the victim's photos, videos, or any information online, impersonating identities of victims online, or posting lies about victims to harm their reputation, or filing false abuse reports to online platforms to silence victims. So, ngayon, sa panahon ngayon that I mentioned nga na we do a lot of our work online, so mag-ingat po talaga tayo because we could be penalized, no, by committing what's been mentioned here in section 12, no, under this law. Okay, so the penalties for gender-based online sexual harassment, next slide please, is that the penalty of prison correctional in its medium period are a fine of not less than 100,000 pesos, but not more than not more than 500,000 pesos or both at the discretion of the court shall be imposed upon any person found guilty of any gender-based online sexual harassment. If the perpetrator is a juridical person, its license or franchise shall be automatically deemed revoked and the persons liable shall be the officers thereof, including the editor or reporter in the case of print media, and the station manager, editor, and broadcaster in the case of broadcast media. An alien who commits gender-based online sexual harassment shall be subject to deportation proceedings after serving sentence and payment of fines. So we have here one question from the OSCST guide from Ms. Geraldine Sacro. The question is there a prescription of crime under 11.3.1.3? Yes, the answer is yes. The crimes under 11.1.3 has a prescriptive period. No, later on, I will share with you, no? I will share with you or inform you of the prescriptive period of offenses committed under Republic Act 11.3.1.3. Next slide, please. So, under Article 3, no, of under Article 3, it provides for the qualified gender-based streets, public spaces, and online sexual harassment. So, ano bang ibig sabihin ng qualified gender-based streets, public spaces, and online sexual harassment? Ang ibig sabihin ng qualified is that if the conditions no provided by law are present, no. Otherwise, if the conditions provided by law are not present, then it would just still be a harassment, but it's not qualified. And the difference, and the only difference between the harassment which is not qualified and the qualified sexual harassment is that the penalty is higher, no, higher in degree. Will be applied. So these are the qualified gender-based streets, no, and online sexual harassment under Section 15. Letter A, if the act takes place in a common carrier or public utility vehicle, including but not limited to jeepneys, taxis, tricycles, or app-based transport network vehicle services, where the perpetrator is the driver of the vehicle and the offended party is a passenger. So, kailangan para maging qualified, kailangan yung perpetrator ay driver and the offended party is passenger. No. So, paano kung yung offender ay pares na passenger? Yung offender ay passenger, yung offended party ay passenger din. Will that be considered as qualified? No. The answer is no. But it would still be a sexual harassment. But it's not going to be considered as qualified under this Section 15 of the law. No. Next is that if the offended party is a minor, a senior citizen, or a person with disability, or a breastfeeding mother nursing her child. No. So, ayon, kung minor daw, senior citizen, or a person with disability, qualified then. If the offended party is diagnosed with a mental problem tending to impair consent. Next, next slide. If the perpetrator is a member of the uniformed services, such as the PNP and the Armed Forces of the Philippines, and the act was perpetrated while the perpetrator was in uniform. Now, the question here is that paano kung naglalakad lang yung PNP or yung AFP pauwi ng bahay na naka-uniform siya tapos nag-commit siya ng sexual harassment, should that be considered as qualified sexual harassment? Well, my opinion is that, yung opinion ko ito, no, I hope may iba rin tayong opinion na makukuha sa ating mga kasamahan dito. My opinion is that it will not be considered as qualified sexual harassment, because my interpretation of this provision is that yung in uniform, it means that on duty siya, the PNP or the Armed Forces of the Philippines personnel must be on duty. Parang ang ano lang nila is that was in uniform, but it could mean that they are actually on duty.
Na-unmute ka po, attorney.
Okay. If the act takes place in the premises of a government agency offering frontline services to the public and the perpetrator is a government employee. So, ayan. Again, sa mga nasa gobyerno, mga kasamahan natin sa gobyerno, so mag-ingat po tayo kasi we can be charged of sexual harassment if we commit sexual harassment while we are actually on duty, no, rendering public service So, if you will see, balik muna natin doon sa Article 3, no? If you will see, yung common nila, no, from A, B, C, D, E na ito, this is like parang the offender is taking advantage, no, of the weaker party, no, like kanina yung may minor, senior citizen, passenger. So yun ang pinaka common nila dito, no, that the offender is taking advantage, no, of the weaker party. So that makes it now qualified. So next slide, please. Under the next slide natin is that this speaks of, provides for the gender-based sexual harassment in the workplace, no? So next slide, please. So section 16 of the gender-based sexual harassment in the workplace includes the following, no? Letter A, an act or series of acts involving any unwelcome sexual advances, requests or demand for sexual favors, or any act of sexual nature, whether done verbally, physically, or through the use of technology such as text messaging or electronic mail, or through any other forms of information and communication systems that has or could have a detrimental effect on the conditions of an individual's employment or education, job performance, or opportunities. Next slide, please. Letter B, it's an act of sexual nature and other conduct based on sex affecting the dignity of a person, which is unwelcome and reasonable and offensive to the recipient, whether done verbally, physically, or through the use of technology such as text messaging or electronic mail, or through any other forms of information and communication systems. Next. Also under this section, a conduct that is unwelcome and pervasive and creates an intimidating, hostile, or humiliating environment for the recipient, provided that the crime of gender-based sexual harassment may also be committed between peers, and those committed to a superior officer by a subordinate, or to a teacher by a student, or to a trainer by a trainee. And letter D, this information and communication system refers to a system for generating, sending, receiving, storing, or otherwise processing electronic data messages or electronic documents, and includes the computer system or other similar devices by or in which data are recorded or stored, and any procedure related to the recording or storage of electronic data messages or electronic documents. So I think the DOLE, no, the DOLE came out already with guidelines on this, not to implement this section 16 of Republic Act 11313. No? So we will not discuss so much of the sexual harassment in the workplace. So let's move to the next section, please, which is para talaga sa atin ito, no? So Article 5 of 11313 provides for the gender-based sexual harassment in educational and training institutions. Since most of the participants are coming from educational institutions, so I really hope that we've started complying with the provisions of 11313, no, the requirement for the educational institutions, particularly for this section. So next slide, please. So under section 21, gender-based sexual harassment in educational and training institutions. It provides that all schools, whether public or private, shall designate an officer in charge to receive complaints regarding violations of this act and shall ensure that the victims are provided with a gender-sensitive environment that is both respectful to the victim's needs and conducive to truth-telling. So I really hope that the institutions are compliant, no, with respect to this requirement that is to designate an officer in charge that is the duty of which is to receive complaints regarding violations of this act. So I'm not sure if we have data in Region 11 regarding this, no. So if our HEIs and our SUCs in Region 11 are compliant with this provision. So you can, for those who have complied with this, you can say yes sa chat room natin, no, para malaman natin, or our Region 11 could get also information whether you've started designating or complying with this provision. Okay, next slide. Still under this section, it is also required that every school must adopt and publish grievance procedures to facilitate the filing of complaints by students and faculty members, even if an individual does not want to file a complaint or does not request that the school take any action on behalf of a student or faculty member, and school authorities have knowledge or reasonably know about the possible or impending act of gender-based sexual harassment or sexual violence. So it is a requirement that even if the individual that is a victim of sexual harassment, or the student, no, for that, for student or official, no, that's a victim of sexual harassment in the school, even if they do not file a complaint, do not want to file a complaint, the management, the school management, no, or the administrator should, if they have knowledge that such incident happened, they have to take, no, action by conducting investigation to determine whether there is truth to the to the claims, no, or to the information, whether such really happened, or sexual harassment really happened, no, in the school premises. Also, if a school knows or reasonably or should know about acts of gender-based sexual harassment or sexual violence being committed that creates a hostile environment, the school must take immediate action to eliminate the same acts, prevent the recurrence, and address their effects. Next slide. And once a perpetrator is found guilty, the educational institution may reserve the right to strip the diploma from the perpetrator or issue an expulsion order. So under this provision, the institution, after, of course, the conduct of investigation by providing the parties due process, no, the educational institution may reserve the right to strip the diploma. Stripping of diploma is, that is the right of the institution, no, from stripping of diploma from the perpetrator or issue. Aside from the stripping of diploma, the institution may also issue or issue an expulsion order to the perpetrator if found guilty. However, in the case of the expulsion order under the Manual of Regulations for Private Higher Education of the Commission, expulsion order may only be implemented after the case is confirmed by the Commission on Higher Education, no? In any case, no? Because under the MORFE, there are actually three penalties, no, that the institution may issue against the student, no, against the offending student. First is that could be suspension, dismissal, dismissal, and of course the highest would be the expulsion, which under the Morphes I mentioned, it requires the confirmation of the commission. Also, the institution is required to constitute a committee on decorum and investigation, no? Which is the duty of which is to address gender-based sexual harassment and online sexual harassment in accordance with the rules and procedures contained in the coding manual. So I hope that, and I'm, of course, no, because of this or because of this law, I am sure that most of the institutions already under Region 11 have created CODI to address this concern, no, as required under Section 21 of the law. Next. Okay, under Section 22, duties of school heads. No, the school heads shall have the following duties. No, one is to disseminate or post a copy of this act in a conspicuous place in the educational institution, provide measures to prevent gender-based sexual harassment in educational institutions, create an independent internal mechanism or a CODI to investigate and address complaints of gender-based sexual harassment. Next slide. Section 22, yes. Yes, in creating the CODI under Section 22, the law provides that it should be adequately represent the school administration, the trainers, instructors, professors, or coaches, and students or trainees, students and parents, as the case may be, no? Number two is to designate a woman as its head, and not less than half of its members should be women. And number three, to ensure equal representation of persons of diverse sexual orientation, identity, or expression in the CODI as far as practicable. So, medyo naging with respect to item number two, no, item number two, wherein the law requires that the head of the CODI should be a woman. Medyo may mga naging diskusyon, no, and diskusyon dito because some groups feel that this requirement of the law requiring that it's only a woman that should head the CODI ay medyo may pagka gender bias siya, no? But then again, when we discussed this with PCW, the PCW explained that even during the crafting of the law and even during the crafting of the implementing rules and regulations, the legislators natin, the reason for this is that based on data is that karamihan pa din, oh, while there are male offended, may mga males tayo na victims of sexual harassment, not just males but also mga members ng LGBTs. But based on data, marami pa rin daw talaga or mas mataas pa din yung data na babae pa din ang biktima, mga kababaihan pa din ang biktima ng sexual harassment. And that is why the IRR and even the law made sure that it should be woman para mas maging komportable yung ating mga sexual harassment victims natin when they report, no, when they report the incidents, no, kaya babae ang nilagay, no, nilagay ng batas natin na maging head ng ating CODI natin. Next slide.
Attorney, nawala ho yung Hello?
Hello? Yes?
Hello, attorney?
Yes?
Lang po, kasi nawala yung internet ng isang co-host.
Nawala yung?
Yung connection ng internet.
Anong office natin?
Ay, sir, sa chat po ito, si Sheila.
Hello? Narinig niyo ba ako?
Hello sir, I'm sorry, nawala po kami, nawala po rin ng linya namin sa Chedro 11. Takabalik
lang. Ah, sa Chedro 11.
Yes, yes po.
Okay. Oh, let me know lang if we can continue na ha. Oo.
Yes po, attorney.
Okay. So, can we now continue? Okay.
Yes, yes,
so, kanina na ito. Next slide na please. Next slide. So, okay. So under section 23 no, ito no, yung mga liability ng school heads natin no. Any person who violates subsection A of this section shall upon conviction be penalized with a fine of not less than 5,000 pesos nor more than 10,000 pesos, or any person who violates subsection B of this section shall upon conviction be penalized with a fine of not less than 10,000 pesos nor more than 15,000 pesos. Next slide. So for our students naman, meron ding liability no yung ating mga estudyante under this law. So minor students who are found to have committed acts of gender-based sexual harassment shall only be held liable for administrative sanctions by the school as stated in their school handbook. So siguro to address this, dapat talaga naka-reflect sa ating mga handbooks natin no yung provisions na yon ng batas na ito no as required under this section of Republic Act 11313. So any questions so far before I share with you what we are doing at present here in CHED with respect to the requirement under Republic Act 11313. Yes, the answer there, Ms. God Center, Ms. DOCST, DOSCST, under Section 22, yes. Oh, that should be part of the sub-provisions of sa handbook natin. Oh, dapat ma-incorporate natin yung provisions ng batas sa ating handbook. Well, before I continue with the other slides, no, yung parang recap lang ng ating presentation ngayon this morning, I would just like muna to share with you at present kung ano ang ginagawa namin sa Commission on Higher Education, no, also as part of gender and development function of GAD function of the on this, no. At present, of course, you're all familiar with CMO number 1, no, series of 2015, no. This was issued in 2015, wherein the title of this CHED memorandum is the establishing the policies and guidelines on gender and development in the Commission on Higher Education and Higher Education Institutions, no. Part 14 of this CMO number 1 is on compliance with laws and issuances on women empowerment, no, which includes sexual harassment and other related sexual offenses. Mm-hmm. However, the basis of this provision of our CMO number 1, yung 7877 lang, no, yung Republic Act 7877, because at that time, in 2015, wala pa naman din yung 11313. That is the reason why na in coordination with all our gender and development focal persons in all the regional offices of the commission, we are in the process of amending no some parts of CMO number 1, which will now reflect the provisions of 11313. We are now in the final stage of the amendment, and hopefully before the year ends, we will be able to present to the CEB the final version of the proposed amendment to CMO number 1. And then, after the approval of the Commission in Bank on the proposed amendment, we will be subjecting the proposed amendments to public consultation. So, as early as now, I would like to parang inform you that one of these days we'll be inviting you to participate in the conduct of public consultation with respect to the proposed amendment to CMO number 1. No, so after that. The public consultation, we will bring it back again to the commission for approval. And once approved, incorporating all the comments, no, that we will be getting from the conduct of the public consultation, we'll incorporate that, and then we'll again bring it back to the commission in bank for approval. And once approved, we will again conduct orientation naman para for all of our stakeholders to implement and comply no itong ating CMO number 1 natin. Okay, so far any questions before I proceed with the other slides? No,
Attorney, can I raise a question, please?
Yes,
clarification lang po. Attorney, in 7877 RA 7877 po, ang nakalagay doon kapag naharas yung babae, ang pinapaboran yung babae dahil feeling niya yun, she was being harassed and by any person, no. Tapos ano, wala nang pangailangan na witness for this. So is this still carried to the new RA na ang babae talaga ang kapag nafi-feel ng babae na harass talaga siya yung listen to or siya yung binibigyan talaga ng halaga in terms sa kanyang testimony.
Yes, ma'am, that is correct, because it's only the offended party that could feel that, no? Walang ibang pwedeng magsabi, no? Because remember, sexual harassment could be for others ay hindi sexual harassment, no? But there are some acts na sexual harassment sa iba hindi naman. So if you feel as a woman, ngayon hindi lang babae, no? Under 11313, hindi lang babae, kahit lalaki, members ng LGBTQ, if you feel that you are offended by the action, no? By the action of another person, no? Another person that you feel that action violates you, then you can file a case, no, under this law, ma'am. Mm-hmm.
Okay, no need for any witness for that, attorney.
Well, of course, ma'am, no. My opinion is that it really depends on the one hearing it, no. Because hindi naman porke na ikaw ang nakakaramdam if hindi na kailangan ng witness. It really depends on the one imposing the penalty. Like in the case, sa kaso po, if you file it before the courts, then if the law or if the judge hearing the case would require the presentation of witnesses, then you have to. But if there are offenses na hindi naman na kailangan talaga ng witness. Mm-hmm.
Okay po. Thank you so much po.
Thank you. Okay, so we can move now to the next slide. So this is just like a recap, no, of what we've presented, no, a while ago, no. So ito pa, just to simplify everything, no. So first is that who can commit gender-based sexual harassment, no. So now under 11.3.1, anyone can commit gender-based sexual harassment. This includes now people on the street, those with authority, influence, or moral ascendancy, such as teachers, trainers, or superiors, peers, such as classmates or friends, or subordinates, no, such as employees, trainees, or students. Next slide. So where can it happen? First is streets, public places, and public utility vehicles, online, workplace, and in schools. Next slide. What to do if you are harassed? First is that you assess the situation, if it's best to confront or ignore your harasser. Immediately go somewhere safe. No? You call the attention or help of your family, friends, any teacher, school, personnel, or workmate you trust. And number four, you file a formal complaint. Next, what can I do if I was harassed online? Block the person harassing you. Yun ang pinakauna mong gawin. Number two, you report the profile, accounts, or users that are using your identity or are posing as you online. Number three, you take screenshots and other evidences of online harassment. Number four, you report or file a complaint to the PNP Anti-Cybercrime Group. Next is that, what do I do if my classmate, friend, or workmate experience sexual harassment? First is provide support. Don't be a bystander if you witness someone being sexually harassed. Suggest to your classmate, friend, or workmate to call the attention or help of their family member, teacher, school personnel, or workmate that they trust. Or inform your classmate, friend, or workmate that they could file a complaint. Next slide, please. And of course, ang pinaka-importante sa lahat para iwasan natin ito ay simple advice to all of us, let us be prudent in all our actions. So, last slide. So, thank you very much. Thank you for listening. I hope I've shared with you something for helpful information today. So, maraming salamat sa inyong lahat.
Salamat po, attorney. That's so enlightening.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much, Attorney Septon. That was very informative. You may be able now to differentiate, no, between RA 787 and RA 11313, wherein sa 787, offenders could only be those with influence or moral ascendancy, and the harassment takes place lang sa workplace or institutional or training facilities. And sa RA 11313 naman, anybody can be the offender, and the harassment takes place not only sa workplace or educational or training facilities, but as well as sa public spaces and also to online sexual harassment. So with this 11313 law, somehow, marunong na tayo on how to address existing gaps and issues on equality, security, and safety of both women and men in private and public spaces. So thank you so much, attorney, for your inputs. And before we proceed with the open forum, let us again call on Ms. Lourdes Cesar, Chapter 11 GAD focal point person, to award the Certificate of Recognition to our guest speaker.
I have the honor to award this certificate. So please, I read the citation. Sector, Republic of the Philippines, Office of the President, Commission Higher Education, Regional Office 11. This certificate of recognition is hereby awarded to Attorney Septon A. De La Cruz, Director 3, Administrative and Financial and Management Service, and GAD Focal Committee Chairperson of the Commission on Higher Education for his explanatory contribution as resource speaker on the topic RA11313, otherwise known as the Safety Spaces Act, during the CHED Regional Office 11 webinar in the observance of the 18-day campaign on End Violence Against Women and Children on December 9, 2020 via Zoom. Given this 9th day of December 2020 at CHED Regional 11, Davao City, Philippines. Signed, Dr. Maricar R. Casquejo, Regional Director, CHEDRO 11. So let's bid a virtual clap with Attorney Septon for giving us a very informative and educational information regarding the RA 11313. Thank you very much, Dr. Attorney Sep.
Okay, maraming maraming salamat, Lourdes, at sa buong Region 11, no, headed by Director Casquejo. But before I leave this yung Zoom natin ngayon, webinar natin, allow me na lang to plug, no, mag-promote lang din ako, because on December 11, the central office, the CHED central office, will also be conducting a webinar, no, still in line with the celebration of this 18-day campaign, no, to end violence against women and children. We'll have one full day activity. So we've issued already the memorandum on this, no, inviting all our GAD focal officers or focal committee of our HEIs and our SUCs, no. So I hope ma-issue ni Lourdes, no. Lourdes, did you get already a copy of the memo?
Yes, attorney.
Oh, please help us invite our friends there in Region 11 to attend. No, we have speakers from in the morning, we have a speaker from Canada, no, from Canada, and in the afternoon, we have also one speaker from the Department of Justice. So I hope to see all of you on December 11. So maraming maraming salamat po.
Yes. Actually, attorney, I give the information prior to the start of the webinar this morning, because I want them to attend this particular activity of central office, because this is a very important information for each higher education institution, especially the guidance counselor, the other, the PUDI, and the GAD focal point system in each higher education institution in Region 11. So at this moment, I will send this memorandum to all our group chat with the different
directors
and coordinators to attend this very special activity in hosted by the central office. So thank you very much also for sharing this, attorney, because this is a very important activity, you know, important information drive for our higher education institution in the Region 11.
Okay, thank you, Lourdes. Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, so... Okay na tayo, no?
Baka may other questions pa for Attorney Septon before he leaves?
Oh, i-grab na may opportunity to ask question with Attorney Septon kung meron pa kayong dapat na i-clear with 11313, kasi i-disseminate or i-reorient, re-echo ninyo ito sa kanilang institution. So any other question? Habang nandito pa si attorney.
Attorney, can I raise one question, please?
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Yeah. I've heard that once nasa isang public utility ka, and then yung passenger to passenger, yung commission ng crime, ng harassment, kung hindi pwede yung RA ngayon, no, can we file an act of lasciviousness for that?
Yes, pwede din po, ma'am. Pwede din po, acts of lasciviousness. But, of course, that would still fall under sexual harassment, no? If sexual harassment, it's just that hindi lang siya qualified, ma'am. The penalty would be lower than that provided for under the section of qualified gender-based, no?
Okay.
Yung difference lang po noon is that yung kanina, we discussed, no, the penalties provided, no, under the usual harassment, no, the usual harassment. But if the conditions provided doon sa section na yon ay sa section ay present, then that makes the sexual harassment qualified and the penalty would be 1 degree higher, no, 1 degree higher lang po.
Okay po. Thank you so much po, attorney.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Any more? Any more question for attorney? Parang wala na. So, we will now proceed to our next activity. And now, no, that all are already informed, updated, and clarified sa mga tanong, we will now call on our Chief Administrative Officer, Dr. Emma K. Bonsobre, for her closing message. Dr. Bonsobre.
I think Ma'am Emma is not around, no, kasi may mga importante siguro na ano na i-follow up. So in behalf of the Commission on Higher Education, I would like to thank every participants in this day, no, December 9 na binigyan niyo ng time, no, yung ginawa namin na activity for this morning para lang magkaroon kayo ng information drive, especially for those questioning about the RA 11313 with Attorney Septon's enlightenment with this Republic Act 11313. I know that a lot of things that we have learned from this morning, at the same time with Ma'am Presi from the City Health Office, we are also enlightened with the HIV AIDS, because this is also a tremendous issues that we are affecting our both men and women and other gender in the society. So hopefully that with this information or with this education or knowledge that you have learned in this morning activity, you're going to re-echo or share this in your respective institution, because we are expecting you to disseminate this information, not only for you, but also especially for your stakeholders, to the student, because sexual harassment safety spaces up is different from 7877 na sexual harassment. Kasi meron at malaki yung coverage ngayon ng Republic Act 11313, as had mentioned Attorney Septon, no, for a while ago. So thank you very much for giving your time. So in the next activity, especially for those mentioned previously, that you will be also attending, so that a lot of information and knowledge that you'll gain from this activity, you can also share with your stakeholders, especially for the student, the faculty, and even in the community when you are implementing your gender and development activity. So in behalf of the Commission on Higher Education, we would like to thank the speaker, Attorney Septon de la Cruz and Ma'am Presi Seno for having us this morning, and then all the participants in your giving your time for today's activity. So thank you very much, and bless us all, and have a good lunch. So, lunch na, no? Kasi 12 o'clock na ata. So thank you very much, Attorney Septon, and thank you very much to all of you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ma'am Lourdes. Okay, participants, attendees, please be informed that certificates of attendance, electronic certificates, no, will be sent to your respective emails right after you answer the post-activity evaluation at the end of this program. So the post-activity evaluation link is in the chat box. Be mindful lang sa mga spelling ng names kasi ang iba nagkakamali pag type in sa letters. So thank you all for attending. This has been Sheila May Fuentes, your MC. And see you on the next GAD activities, and hopefully face-to-face na. Enjoy the rest of the day. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Attorney Seb. Thank you, everyone.
Sige daw.
Yung kamala mag-off on it, Chi. Ayaw lang. Sino ka ba lumang kung ano-ano eh? Asa si Kim? So, ano ko ano pag-out?
Kaya
niya asa ko? Kim? Saan ka? Diyan na dyan.